speak to the officials for tonight's game. The game is now squarely in the hands of referee Bruce Hood. That's he in the middle, senior official of the National Hockey League. Ron Finn and Bob Hodges are the two linesmen. And Mr. Hood is in charge from here. Michel Dion, goaltender for the Pittsburgh Penguins. We've talked about him. There's his season record. He is 2-2, of course, in the playoffs. And for the New York Islanders, the veteran Bill Smith. He as well in the playoffs, 2-1, his record in the series against Pittsburgh, a 1.63 goals against average in the series. Nystrom started on right wing with Born on the left side and Goring at center. Morrow and Potman on the points, and it was Morrow dumping it into the Pittsburgh zone. Nystrom in with a good check on center. Bobby Nystrom throwing his weight around very early. Goring in trying to dig it off the boards. Now Nystrom taken out by Carlyle. Worked it around to the left side. Potman, the board. Bob Bourne, the Morrow, moves in. A shot to the point. Tipped by Goring and wide. Picked up by Bob Bourne. Bourne, around one check. Back to Potman. Knocked away from him at the blue line. And here comes Carlyle. Carlyle, he lets to duck it into the Islander zone and go for a rest. Potman up the left side for Bob Bourne. Islanders, remember, have scored the opening goal in every game thus far. Bossy is out now with Trache, joined by Tonelli, so Al Arbour goes back to an old, tried, trusted, and reliable formula. Bossy to Trache, that was broken up by Price. The right side, Ferguson, dumps it into center ice, coming back is Lantanen. Another pair of time. Another Lantanen up the left wing for Tonelli, who had lost his balance. Here's Baxter into the Islander zone. Drops it to Ferguson. George Ferguson to McLeish, and the shot went wide of the net. Tonelli bumped by Saint-Laurent as he got the puck to Trache. Ryan Trache got away from Ferguson and at center ice dumped it in right on Dion. Dion around the boards intended for Ferguson. Lodgman came in to knock it away from him. Baxter and Tonelli bumped to the corner. Ron Tonelli and Baxter still bumping. It is Baxter starting out for Pittsburgh. Paul Baxter played it rink wide for McClish. Tried to clear it to the Islander line and hit Pearson, picked up by Saint-Laurent. Andre Saint-Laurent slipped it in around Wayne Sutter. Saint-Laurent cuts to the right side. Off his stick and fired wide. There's Keogh with another shot. That went wide. Wayne Sutter bumped off the puck by Bouchette, but Pearson cleared it. Right to Carlyle, however, to Pat Bouchette. Bouchette unable to settle. Smith out of that. Plays it around the boards. In comes Hotham. Hotham to Keogh. It's centered in front. Picked off and cleared by Langevin to Pearson, and he dumps it down the ice. We'll get the first play stoppage here after 2 minutes and 17 seconds of the opening period. Break of the action. The score, Islanders nothing, the Penguins.
For the Pittsburgh Penguins, Pat Bouchette having a fine series, Chicks.
Yeah, considering that he had only a so-so regular season series against the Islanders, he has come up big for them. Bouchette and Hotham, or at least Carlyle, I should say, and Hotham are their defense. Gardner was out for the draw. Now he is replaced by Saint-Laurent. Saint-Laurent seeing extra duty. The two centers and Clark Gillies, the forward line for the Islanders. The puck cleared down into the Islanders zone. Potman, as he touched it. Now as Gillies picks it up, icing his call. Potman and Bouchette were down on the ice together. A little shoving. There's Gillies in to take a push. And Bouchette, who is slow getting off the Islander captain.
The teams are wanting to establish the intensity. The Islanders' first shift got things rolling with Bob Nystrom throwing some heavy body checks. Dennis Potvin as he goes back into his own end of the ice to the left of Billy Smith. Bouchette going in after him. Bouchette has him at a disadvantage. See Potvin's right hand come up. Pop Bouchette one after Bouchette had taken the Islander captain heavily into the boards.
The call was for icing, the result of faceoff to the left of Michel Dion. Later tonight, Los Angeles at Edmonton. That series even at 2 apiece, and they're playing back-to-back as Edmonton defeated the Kings 3-2 in Los Angeles last night. Tonight, they move to Edmonton. And the other series to be completed tonight is at the Forum in Montreal, the Nordiques and the Canadiens. And it is underway. The scores come in, we'll pass them along. Here's Goral from the blue line. His shot right on. Dion the save. Gillies pushes his bat off the puck, trying to center it, ties up Gardner, and there is Carlyle, got away from Morrow. Racing it is Danny Potvin, Gets back to Carlyle. Hoffman ball on defense. Red Sutter, Rain Sutter, and Park Gillies to forwards. Long pass by Hoffman, failed to connect. Arbour checked by Gillies. Gillies puts it up against Sutter. Over the Pittsburgh line, round to the right side. Rain Sutter shot went high. Comes back to Hoffman, off the board to be fired at wide. Oral will pick it up at center ice. Boutette chasing him. Oral over to Denny Hoffman. Hoffman folded away from Boutette, slipped it into center ice to Goring, jacking in around Hoffman. Goring comes in to pick out. Born and Price go to the boards. Born got it to Goring. Hoffman takes him off the puck. There's Bullard. Greg Bullard, number 22. Greg Mike. Mike Bullard centering it. Goes to Bob Born. To Nystrom. Nystrom, Born, and Goring move into center ice. Three Penguins back. Nystrom over the line. Trying to come in around Baxter. Nystrom back to the net. Checked by Pat Price. Price to Ferguson, Nystrom on top of him, Goring in as well. Goring trying to slap it away from Ferguson, did, but it hit Pat Price. And Price backhands it down the ice. Wide of Bill Smith, but this will go for an icing call. There's a break in the action. The score, New York Islanders nothing, the Pittsburgh Penguins back to their bench. Bruce Hood has refereed in over 90 National Hockey League playoff games, second only to Bill Chadwick. Hall of Famer Bill Chadwick.
Really? It's up that high now for Bruce.
That high. Two fine referees. Bruce Hood. Couldn't get a shot away. Trache with it. Back with the net to Bossy. The Trache. Hood was knocked down. The puck went loose. Tonelli worked it back to the Pittsburgh goal. Picked up by Hoffman. Hoffman up the left wing out of the reach of Rick McLeish. Coming back toward his forward lane. And McEwen together on defense. Trache, Tonelli, and Bossy the forward line. Laurent is out there for Pittsburgh as Tonelli fires from around the boards. Bossy in after him. Mike Bossy in front to Tonelli on the backhand. He shoots Dion. It's not him saved, and Dion pulled over. The puck was loose. But Tonelli rolled Dion over, knocking his face mask off. Now the Penguins look for Tonelli. They'll have a face off to the left of that.
Bruce Hood calls it as a hand pass, stopping the play. Intensity by the Islanders. They want to jump all over the Pittsburgh Penguins. Here's Mike Bossy trying to corral the puck. That's private Kevin McClelland, number 18 in front. Right on the stick of John Tonelli. Lets the backhand go. He gets pushed into the goaltender, Michel Dion. That's how he ended up on top of him.
Now the Islanders making a late player change. Al Arbour sending out Wayne Merrick, Bob Born, and Anders Kaller.
The first two games here at the Nassau Coliseum, the off-ice officials were from the Hartford Whalers. Tonight, they're from Madison Square Garden.
These gentlemen worked the two games in Pittsburgh on the weekend, and here they are for the conclusion of the series. Wayne Merrick has had an excellent playoff. Three goals against Pittsburgh. Dion taking some time, putting the face mask on again, talking to Bruce Hood. They've been shaken up a little bit in that collision with Tonelli.
Get disoriented easily when you're in the position of staring at the puck, making a move on it, and one of your defensemen in this case shoves an opposing player in on top of you.
4:48 gone in the opening period. Merrick on the faceoff. Laurent for Pittsburgh. Wayne Merrick squares in. The puck finally dropped, and Laurent won the draw, getting it to Price. Pat Price up the left side, out of the reach of shot. Chasing it is Langevin. He and McClelland get there together. Langevin touched it first, so Pittsburgh has iced it.
Good hustle by Dave Langevin. Kevin McClelland, he's long and he's gangly, and he's young, hasn't finished growing. He does not look like he's fast, but he has long legs, and he makes the move. Keeping him in stride. Oshawa Boyd.
That's the way
he's done well, you know, particularly the second game in Pittsburgh, the fourth game of the series. He was an outstanding player in the hockey game on this line that he's on now.
Long and gangly is the way they used to describe another guy that wore 18 that came from Oshawa and played in Niagara
yeah.
Falls.
Yeah, he still is.
That Price chased back to the goal by Thorne. Got it around to Baxter. Oh, Baxter. Rink wide out of the reach of Laurent. It's picked up by Pearson. The Bourne over to the Pittsburgh line. Here's Taylor coming in off right wing. to board, and it was broken up by Baxter. Baxter checked. Laurent got it to Pearson from the blue line. His shot was deflected. Born tied up at the side of the goal, and Paul Baxter is going to draw his first minor penalty of this series.
It's going to be a holding penalty. Paul Baxter, a break in the action here at the Coliseum. There is. When one presents itself, take advantage. Stephon Pearson checked. Here's the penalty right there, a holding penalty. Baxter on Bob Bourne. Can the Islanders take advantage with the power play? They're operating at 20%, well below their season's average here in the playoffs.
Three goals on 15 chances. They got the draw, and it's Pearson giving it to Bossy. Mike Bossy in on the right side. Bossy around Carlyle center, picked up by Dion. The puck loose, and Boutet chases it. At Boutet, hooked by Krejci, and the power play is gone. Krejci will go to the box. They're calling it holding.
The power play nullified. Brian Krejci is going to get the gate as he catches Pat Boutin coming out of his own end. Krejci reaches out, grabs a hold. There you are, with his left hand, pulls him down, gets a penalty. The Islanders lose their opportunity. Speaking of the Islanders' power play, Jigs, it's 2-for-10 here at the Coliseum for 20%, 1-for-5 at Pittsburgh for the same 20%. And the Penguins are 2-for-10 here for 20, but they're only 1-for-11 in their own building for 9%.
1-for-11?
1-for-11 in Pittsburgh.
Wait, how can that be? They got two power play goals there the other night.
That's what our stat guys gave us. Haven't they got a total of three?
Yeah.
Power play goals? 2-for-10 and 1-for-11?
Tonelli battled Hoffman for control of the puck in the Pittsburgh zone. It came loose. Hoffman's shot was steered aside by Dion, picked up by McClelland. Waves around to Hoffman. Hoffman into center ice. And to Carlyle, backhands it into the Islanders zone. It's got about four balls. There's no score in the first period. Ball over the left wing boards for Hoffman. Jabbed it right to George Ferguson. Ferguson tapping it back. Mark 20. Moves it into the Islanders zone. 40 seconds remaining in the penalty to Baxter, and then Pittsburgh will have a 19-second man penalty. Here is Wayne Merrick down left wing. Bucking it into the Pittsburgh zone. Gillies in after it. Gillies knocked it away from Chorney. Back of the goal. Gillies and Chorney trying to tie up one another. The puck kicked around the boards, and that's Pat Price with it. Price at the blue line. At center ice. Price slowed up the play and then forced the Islanders to go back. Poppan to Clark Gillies. Gillies, Merrick, Pearson, and Poppan. This is Pearson at center. Overskated it. Picks it up again. Across the Pittsburgh line with Merrick. Pearson chased to the corner. Right up on the boards. Overcomes Merrick. Just as Baxter had stepped out of the penalty box. But now a faceoff in the Pittsburgh zone. Krejci still with 18 seconds to serve in his holding penalty.
Plus minuses can be fun at times as we watch Paul Baxter head for the Pittsburgh players' bench. Islanders, Brent Sutter, Gord Lane, each have a plus six in this series. Clark Gillies is plus five. For Pittsburgh, Greg Hotham is a plus one. Paul Gardner is a plus one. No other Penguins have a plus. You have to look back to the first two games with all the goals against Pittsburgh to see that that's the reason there are only two players with a plus on Pittsburgh, but they're still tied in the series at two games apiece.
Now 5 seconds remaining in the Islander penalty. The delayed offside is called as Billy Carroll took it deeper in his own zone. So they'll face off out in the center ice area with 3 seconds left in the Islander penalty.
Jigs, when Brian Krejci, there's a guy right there, Billy Carroll, what a tail end of the season he had as he started to play a little more, but he's been brilliant with the Islanders. They're penalty killing 87.0% efficiency. That is more than good. That is better than excellent. What do you say for that?
What would it be?
Brilliant. Okay. You know, you talk about specialty teams and so on. Dennis Botvan a minute ago went in trying to take a pass to get his team a goal on the power play. Sometimes that could be looked at as doing just trying to do a little too much. Krejci gets a penalty. Botvan's in by the net. Botvan hasn't had a point in the game so far, but he leads the Islanders with 15 shots.
That was Tonelli blasting one off the left wing boards, off the stick of Dion and into the crowd. A break in the action. The score, Islanders nothing, Penguins nothing.
For him, a newfound position on the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Facing off against Butch Goring, Nystrom and Bourne, the rest of the forwards for the Islanders. Langevin and Pearson on defense. Laurent has McClelland to the right. Shot on the left side. Goring tied him up, but the Penguins control the puck. That's Hotham. Young defenseman to Laurent. Out of McClelland. The Islander line. He tried to feed it to Shot on left wing. Pearson runs into the boards. The puck loose. Shot put it out in front, but right on the stick of Bourne. And Nystrom rang Shot heavily after he made the play. Shot is just now getting to his skates. Referee Bruce Hood has called the play, thinking that Shot was injured.
Goalie Smith slams his stick on the ice in protest. They stopped the play. Shot had gotten up and was headed for the bench or back into the play. Bruce Hood stopped the play. The Islanders on a 3-on-2 break heading into Pittsburgh's end of the ice. There's Shot, gets hammered by Bob Nystrom. Stefan Pearson falls heavily into the boards. We've seen players dislocate their shoulders on the same kind of a fall. Here's Shot on one leg, back on the other, and Nystrom reefs him, taking him in heavily. That will dislodge the balance and the thinking for a while, but he seems to be all right.
Well, he's going to go to the Pittsburgh bench for a little rest. He wanted to stay out there, but Eddie Johnson has made a line change. Ferguson, McLeish has moved back to left wing with Bullard at center ice. This is a line that they used in the first game against the Islanders, and now Laurent came out on the ice late.
Yes, Eddie Johnson made two changes. He's not allowed. He took Bullard off, put Andy St. Laurent back on, but you're going to see Bullard back out onto the ice.
Bullard comes back to face off against Brent Sutter. Now the Islanders are making a change. Trache has come out with Gillies and Wayne Sutter, and Bruce Hood says, wait a minute.
Well, Bruce Hood is actually wrong, but he's not going to let Al Arbour overrule him. Trache actually came out. Then he went back, came out again. They're going to make Brent Sutter stay on the ice.
So it's Sutter against Bullard, and the Islanders got the draw. Lane shooting it around the boards. Dion cut it off for Baxter. All Baxter hit solidly by Dwayne Sutter. Now Trache is out there, and he ran into his man in the corner. The puck came to Ferguson. Into the Islander zone, taken out by McEwen. Jacob Lane came over to pick up the puck. Ford Lane chased by Bullard. Lane dumps it into center ice. There is Pat Price. And McLeish, rolled over by Trache's body check. Baxter upended by Gillies, and Clark will get a penalty.
It's going to be a tripping penalty. Bruce Hood standing right beside him when it happened. A break in the action with the score. The Islanders nothing. Second penalty goes to Clark Gillies. Trache had the first for holding. Gillies gets it for tripping.
Well, Pittsburgh on a power play. Boutet shot was blocked by Morrow. And here's Carlyle around the boards to Gardner. Put it out in front for Boutet. And Boutet to Paul Gardner. To Boutet. Boutet pulled it away from Goring. Back to the blue line. That's Hotham to Boutet. Goring stabbed it away from him. Boutet to Hotham. Came over to Keogh and a shot hit Morrow. Willie Carroll snaps on it. Gets it out of there. Going back is Hotham. Killing it off. Goring, Carroll, Morrow, and Potvin. So Hotham leads the rush. Up the right side to Boutet. Pat Boutet, centering attempt. Cut off and cleared by Morrow. He had Carlyle moving up the wing, but Morrow, anticipating, handled it well.
Smart play by Kenny Morrow. Jakes moved into the hole, intercepting the pass.
Now a minute 10 remaining in this power play, and Tyler does trip his man, Boutet, of the puck. Horn is upended by Hotham. This is Carlyle. Hoffman took a run at him. Gardner with the pass to Keogh. Spit the save. Morrow slaps it out of there.
Good stop by Billy Smith. Point blank
on Gardner. Now Boutet comes in over the line on right wing. Haller on top of him. Chased him to the corner. Langevin in there. He got Gardner down. The puck comes back on the right wing boards. It's Keogh. Rick Keogh. To Pat Boutet. To Pat Price. To Baxter. Baxter a shot. Smith got a piece of it. The puck goes to Langevin. Langevin shoots it out of there with 25 seconds left in the penalty time against Gillies.
And good work by Langevin and Keller. They got their positions mixed up. Keller was playing defense.
Now the Penguins unable to get organized at center ice. Price is chased into his own zone by Goring. Price fell. The puck went to Bullard. Bullard to Price. Chase up the left side to Ferguson over the Islander line. And on the breaks, fed it to McLeish. Gillies is back on. McLeish checked by Goring, and Gillies takes over. Right and up the right side, off the stick of Ferguson, and into the Islander players' bench. 9:05 remaining in the opening period. A standing ovation for the Islander penalty killers.
The fans realize how much it means, Jake. The Islanders kill off what is normally a routine penalty, and the fans give the Islanders penalty killers a standing ovation. Stefan Pearson, I wonder if that fall that he made into the boards a while back, along with Shutt, is the reason that Stefan Pearson is heading for the Islander dressing room, along with trainer Ron Woski.
You hit it right on the head. He went with the trainer, not the equipment man, so it appears to be something in the nature of an injury.
Look into the seats and see where Dr. Jeff Minkoff is sitting. That'll be another signal.
Now Hoppen is into the Islander zone, right into the check of McEwen. The puck loose, Smith poked it into the corner. Mike McEwen with it. McEwen to Bossy, off his stick. Bossy outraces Carlyle, down the right wing. Bossy winds up, he shoots, Dion the save. Lane with the rebound, and that's run up Dion. Now Tonelli out in front. Bossy couldn't get a shot away. Salarant feeds it up left wing for Shutt. Shutt back to Carlyle. Carlyle getting away from Tonelli. Laid it off McClelland's stick at the Islander line. McEwen unable to clear it out on the first attempt. Carries it out on the second. Gave it to Tonelli up the right side. Brian Trache chasing it. Trache to McEwen. Hope checked away by Baxter. Now Shutt moved over and the puck went straight up in the air. Picked up by Baxter as it hit the ice, and Baxter is upended, and the Islanders will be shorthanded. Brian Trache, once the Islanders get control of the puck, Trache will go to the penalty box. But Pittsburgh comes out to center. McClelland just dumped it in. Boyle takes over and the whistle sounds. The penalty here will give Pittsburgh a 6-5 situation. With a break in the action, there is no score between the Islanders and the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Skates gets a tripping penalty, and Pittsburgh get another power play opportunity. Three penalties in a row for the Islanders.
Goring on the draw. Billy Carroll, the other forward. Poffin and Morrow on defense. A lot of movement. Puck finally dropped. Islanders got the draw. Poffin backhanded it down into the Pittsburgh zone.
Another good indication, Jiggs, as to the importance of faceoffs in your own end of the ice.
Kehoe starts the rush. The pass to Hotham. Hotham at center ice. Left side to Carlyle. Carlyle chased deep by Morrow. Carlyle came off the boards, gave it to Hotham. Hotham a centering attempt, and it was tipped by Evgeny Pape. At Putek. Around to Gardner. With a blue line, here is Hotham. Hotham in front to Putek. Had trouble handling it, now drops it back. That's Kehoe. Into Pat Putek. Let it go back to the goal. Carlyle chases it. Billy Carroll steps into Carlyle. Off the boards, it's Hotham with it to Gardner. To Carlyle. Carlyle gave it to Gardner. Smith tried to knock it away from him. It comes up the right boards. Picked up by Kehoe to Pat Putet. A minute to go on this power play. Putet tries to get some motion going. Gave it to Gardner. Back to Putet. Putet shoots one. Smith the stick hand save. Here's Carlyle at the left point. Carlyle to Kehoe. Into Pat Putet. Putet centers. A shot kicked out by Smith as Hotham turned in front of the goal, and now Kenny Morrow picks it up and backs it off the boards down into the Pittsburgh zone.
And good penalty killing by the Islanders again, Jake. Taking the man when they can without taking themselves out of the play.
Now the Penguins trying to come out. The puck deflected off George Ferguson and into the crowd. So they're going to face off in the Pittsburgh territory, just inside the circle to the left of Michel Dion. We have 25 seconds remaining in the penalty time against Trache. 6:27 remaining in this opening period.
If best of five series run true to form, since they were initiated in 1980, three series prior to this year have gone to the fifth game. The home team has won every one.
And no team since this preliminary series has been organized a couple of years ago, no team has ever lost the first two games and come back to win the series. Bullard at the Islander line, went in offside, got a little extra push from Gord Lane after the whistle. 12 seconds remaining in the Pittsburgh power play.
A little memory jogger. Boston beat Pittsburgh April 14, 1980 with a 6-2 score to win the fifth game. St. Louis beat Pittsburgh April 14th, 81, 4-3 in double overtime to beat Pittsburgh. And Philadelphia beat Quebec April 14th, 81, also a 5-2 score.
I saw that St. Louis, in fact, worked that St. Louis-Pittsburgh game. I think I mentioned it the other night. It was one of the real fine hockey games. Up and down. Here's a break for Bob Bourne. Will his feet get him in there? Price came back to knock it away, and it went right to Dion.
Good play by Pat Price. He looked like he was going to be too late, but one quick flick of the wrist, the end of the stick, knocks the puck away. Bourne looks as though he's away. With his speed, the puck won't lay still, but he's got it out in front, and right there, Pat Price got just the tip of the stick on the puck, knocking it away from him. Dion rescued it.
5 seconds remaining in the penalty. You look at Michel Dion. I questioned the voting at the midway point in the season when he was selected as the all-star goaltender from this conference. He has shown us in recent games just why he garnered as many votes as he did.
27-year-old Michel Dion. He's from Granby, Quebec.
Signed as a free agent after splitting last year between Quebec and Winnipeg. Now Lane dumps it around behind the Pittsburgh goal. Gauthier back on to the Penguins. Paul Baxter dumps it into center ice. That is shot. Chased by Brent Sutter. Laurent moved in over the line outside. And finally, they knock shut down as Langevin coming up has leaned into him with his shoulder. And Gillies comes over to have some words with all the rest of the Penguins. There's Gord Lane. Little shoving. Bruce Hood telling them to separate and get it over with, and let's continue to play the game. Ron Waske has returned from the Islander dressing room
without Stefan Pearson.
He did not bring Pearson with him. He just had a, well, he's still talking to Al Arbour about whatever the situation may be. In the first period, Quebec has taken a 1-0 lead over Montreal, and Paymont, who had been out with a knee injury, has scored the goal. Wilf Paymont, whom they acquired at the trading deadline from Toronto, has Quebec in front at the Forum. Here there is no score with a little less than 6 minutes to play in the first period. I'm Jinx McDonald with Ted Westfall. Lord Lane dumped it in wide. Beyond out of the net, banked it off the boards. Picked up by McClelland, and there will be a penalty. Interference penalty against Baxter. All of a sudden, Baxter runs into a penalty, his second of the game. Wayne Sutter moved in, hadn't touched the puck. Nor was he the last man to have touched the puck, and Baxter,
an interference called by the look of the signal from referee Bruce Hood. I did not see that. Maybe we'll have another look at it. Baxter gets called for his second penalty of the hockey game. He had the first penalty of the game at 5:27 for holding.
Is that Terry Crisp sitting down behind the penalty box? It's not, I know, but it's...
You mean the red bushy hair? Is that was your first clue? I can see it from right here. It would look a great deal and does.
Well, not many turns.
One of the original Islanders, Terry Crisp. I think he was an original Islander. He was drafted.
We'll watch an Islander power play, but it went amiss. McEwen's pass intercepted and cleared by Salarat. McEwen and Poppin on the points. Strache, Bossy, and Tonelli up front. It's Poppin lugging it out of his own zone. And Poppin shoots it around the boards. Strache in after it. It came off the boards and into the mesh. Back to the net. Controlled by Strache. Strache out in front. Poppin closed in, and Dion Rockville.
Close call. Poppin gets a pass from Strache. Dion stops it.
Now Bossy pulls it back offside at the Pittsburgh at the Islander blue line. A minute 26 left in this penalty.
That play, Jakes. That play of Dennis Potvin's. He just gets in too close. Potvin rips the puck in around onto the back of the net. Bossy with good speed in, knocks it away. Now Trache comes out. If he could have got the puck a little sooner to Potvin, you see he's in so close. A little further out, he'd have had more net to shoot at. Dion makes the save.
Trache won the draw here, getting it to Tonelli. Now McEwen has fed it to Potvin. Hey, Potvin at center ice again, dumps it in. Dion came out to meet it, couldn't get there. Trache goes back to the net. Tied up by Carlyle. Bossy with it. Bossy back to Potvin. Eddie Potvin to John Tonelli to Bossy. Shoots Dion, the save, the rebound. He got a piece of that and covers up.
What a save by Dion. And Houston announces Carlyle trying to keep Quache away from the goal. And Dion has made the save of the game. On a power play, here's Quache. How hard he's been working trying to get things going. Carlyle, the save for his team. Rossi passes. Potvin is off balance, wheels into the skates. Tonelli, there's the shot. Look at that. 8 times out of 10, the first shot by Bossy or the rebound by Trache would be in the net. Not to be with Dion. He's hot again tonight.
1:04 left in the penalty time to Baxter. Trache facing off against Boutet. Boutet ties up Ryan Trache. Tonelli tied up by Carlyle. And here's Salomont with it. Andre Salomont to the Islander line. McEwen runs into him. Backboard is John Tonelli. A rolling puck. Tonelli has to turn to get away from Boutet. Boutet steals it back to the goal, and Smith knocked it off his stick.
Good check by Billy Smith. Boutet was heading for the front of the net with no Islanders around.
And Denny Potvin at center ice flipped it between the defense. Ferguson got back to give it to Boutet, and he'll force the Islanders back into their own zone.
Talk about doing the things you don't usually do all season long. I've never seen an Islander do that, Jiggs. And here they are on a power play trying to give a soft pass at Pittsburgh's blue line.
Now Bossy moves in, a slap shot, but not 20. Bossy plays it around the boards. It's McEwen on the left point. In deep, to Butch Goring. Goring turned away from one check. Now tries to come in around Price, out in front of the net, back to Potvin. Dennis, and Mike Bossy. Bossy to Goring at the side of the goal. Goring trying to set up somebody, comes back to Potvin, and drive! Beyond the save, Bossy the rebound! That was blocked by Chorney. Chorney snaps it off the boards. The teams are at six aside as Potvin comes back to pick it up. Potvin to McEwen. McEwen drives one around the boards in the Pittsburgh zone. McLeish couldn't take it. Here's Dwayne Sutter. He's checked by McLeish. Rick McLeish out into center ice for Kehoe. Rick Kehoe checked in turn by Gillies. Mark Gillies dumps it into the Pittsburgh zone. Right to Michelle Dion. That's it for Carlyle. Randy Carlyle ahead to Bullard off his stick. It's cleared back by Morrow. Now Bullard having trouble with it again. Played it on board out into center ice. Baxter left it to Kehoe for Bullard. Bullard over the line to Keon. He was checked by Morrow. Now Bourne breaks up. Three men back for Pittsburgh as Merrick moves up, takes Bourne's pass, and then is offside at the Pittsburgh blue line with 2:50 left in the period.
Tension has got him out, particularly on the side of the Islanders. The longer the game goes, Jiggs, with Pittsburgh within one goal of the Islanders, the tougher it gets for them.
We've had a total of 5 penalties, 3 to the Islanders, 2 against the Penguins. No score in this period. Dion has come up big.
Another, did you know? Did you realize that Glenn Resch was in the nets every time the Islanders were eliminated in a playoff game?
No, I didn't know that.
Great trivia.
Malcolm unable to come off the boards in his own zone. Merrick gave it to Nystrom. He couldn't control it. It's stolen by Bourne. Over to Nystrom. Nystrom a drive. Dion the save. Bourne the rebound. Good stop by Dion. Here's Nystrom again. There'll be a Pittsburgh penalty coming up. Bourne a backhander. Hit the post. Dion dives on top of it and play is called. And we'll get a hooking penalty against the Pittsburgh Penguins.
It's that kind of pressure, Jiggs, that the Islanders have to put on Pittsburgh. That drives them to making mistakes and taking penalties. Great pressure as we see Merrick, Nystrom, Bourne is in front of the net as they try to get a hold of the puck right there, intercepted by Bob Bourne. And the pressure begins. Shot. Nystrom. Another shot. Bourne. Another shot. Well, we're coming. It's coming. There it is. Right here. Bobby Bourne, a backhand shot. As Dion does tricks to keep the puck out of the net. Kehoe, number 17, has taken a hooking penalty.
17:36 the time. The Islanders have Trache, Bossy, and Gillies as the forward line. Potvin on the right point, McEwen on the left.
Baxter took the first penalty of the game, then the Islanders took 3 in a row, and now Baxter and Kehoe have taken penalties for Pittsburgh.
It was Baxter clearing the puck with Price at Boutet. Salomont to Boutet, and Gillies runs into him. The puck loose, Salalon in after it. Salalon tied up in the corner. Gratche and McEwen, along with Salalon, forcing a faceoff to the right of Smith.
Good move by Gillies, Jiggs, as he got back quickly. The Islanders were caught. It was a two-on-one, Saint Laurent and Boutet. As they broke away, Gillies, using his speed, got back to help break up the two-on-one advantage. Here they break out. There's Saint Laurent, Boutet. Look at Gillies. You see his feet coming into play right there. Pat Boutet.
Gratche won the draw from Boutet. Poppin over to McEwen. Now back to Denny Poppin. Poppin at the center ice right. Cuts to the left. Over the line. Walked in around Saint Laurent, but then was chased to the boards by Baxter. Got it back to McEwen. The Poppin. The Gillies at the right point. Gillies in front to Fossey, and he couldn't make contact with it. Baxter snaps it out of there. McEwen's backhander, blocked by Dion, who gives it to Baxter. And to McEwen. McEwen around the boards. Pat Price clears it. Poppin races to the blue line. Got it into the corner. Gratche in front to Bossy. Back to Gratche. Gratche raced to the corner by Price. And away from the check, gave the puck to Poppin. Poppin to McEwen. McEwen a drive. Kicked out by Dion. It bounces out into center ice with less than a minute remaining in the penalty to Keyhole.
It's all the little things, Jiggs. You see the shot by McEwen with nobody in front of the net. Dion made the save easily.
Now Tonelli tied up on the boards by Carlyle. It comes back to Poppin. Over to McEwen. McEwen, and his shot is deflected. Tonelli tipped it wide. Rossi from back of the goal. Knocked out the puck by Carlyle, but Tonelli got it to Poppin. Poppin's shot through a screen was wide. Gratche had been belted to the ice in front of the Pittsburgh goal. Bossy in the corner now. Back of the net to Gratche. Stepped into Carlyle. Carlyle trying to clear it out. McEwen comes to the board. Ferguson trying to tie him up. Couldn't do it. McEwen's pass hit Boutet. And Carlyle dumps it into center ice. 15 seconds remaining in the penalty time against Keyhole.
We're now seeing good penalty killing by the Pittsburgh Penguins.
On Tonelli gets to the Pittsburgh line. Trying to come in around Baxter. Nystrom picked it up. Couldn't control it. Salomon has it. Pittsburgh is back at equal strength. And they go offside at the New York Islander blue line with 22 seconds left in a scoreless first period.
A good first period, Jiggs. Good end-to-end action. A lot of action around Michel Dion. Pittsburgh has done a fine job protecting him. But the Islanders are getting their opportunities.
Total of six penalties called, three against each team. It's Goring, Nystrom, and Bourne for the Islanders. Gord Lane, Ken Morrill, the New York Islander defense. Greg Gilbert, Hector Marini, Thomas Johnson not in the Islander lineup tonight. Gilbert had played the first four games on the sidelines with the return of Bob Nystrom.
Rick Keyhole had a penalty a moment ago. His first playoff penalty as a Penguin in 37 games, including tonight. He did not have one as a Toronto Maple Leaf. He did have one, I'm sorry.
Nystrom dumped the puck into the Pittsburgh zone. It came out in front. Bourne got a stick on it. Bob Bourne turning into the corner, back of the net. That's Goring. Put it to the side of the goal, and it's in the mesh as the horn sound, sending a scoreless first period. Both teams with some excellent chances. The Islanders had the better of the chances in the period. But Dion stood them on their ears collectively, as did Bill Smith for the Islanders. Nystrom had himself a good first period. But at the end of one, there is no score. Islanders and Penguins, and we'll be back with a recap following this message. Get to Pittsburgh in the first period, but they come out of it with nothing to show by taking it to them. Just what you see on your screen, 13-4, the shots on goal. The opportunities, scoring opportunities were there, but Dion let nothing by. Scoreless, six penalties. Baxter drew two of them, two minor penalties, something he hadn't done in the previous four games of this playoff, as we pointed out at the beginning, taking only that misconduct penalty. But neither team able to do anything with the manpower advantage, and that could very well be a key once we reach the end of 60 minutes.
It is always a key, Jiggs. The specialty teams, we talk about them regularly, particularly in the playoffs. The Islanders' power play has not been good at all. Pittsburgh's has been worse. The Islanders' penalty killing, of course, has been excellent, or better than excellent, whatever you want to call it. Islanders took the play to them like they wanted to. Pittsburgh had four shots. There was only maybe one I could think of that was any test for Billy Smith. He handled it. But the Islanders continue the way they're going. They're going to have to get some goals because Dion cannot stave off 13 shots a period, particularly when there's at least eight of them that are from point-blank range.
I thought Andre Saint Laurent had himself an excellent period for Pittsburgh. He got an awful lot of ice time.
He did, and he's going to get even more as this game goes along because he's one of the better players in this series. I'm still a little surprised at the fact they do not use Gardner more than they do. He's a good hockey player.
Yeah, I'm not too sure about that one either. But the Islanders and the Penguins are scoreless. Islanders outshot Pittsburgh 13-4 in the first period. And in just a moment, we'll be going to the studio where Stan Fischler is standing by with the former New York Islander and now star of this Pittsburgh team, Andre Saint Laurent.
All seem at the end of a pulsating first period. We have no score between the Islanders and the Pittsburgh Penguins. This is the decisive game of the opening round. And the man to my right, he's not the tallest man in the world, but he has been a giant for the Pittsburgh Penguins, Andre Ace Saint Laurent. You have been absolutely phenomenal, more than a thorn in the Islanders' side, and yet early in the season, you were a forgotten man, and now everybody's talking about you. You must feel sensational.
Well, it's nice to be playing in the NHL, and I'm glad that the Penguins gave me a chance to play, and I'm just trying to do the best I can to help my team win the first round here.
Andre, you've obviously had some instructions how to play Brian Trottier. You've known him from playing here with the Islanders. Generally speaking, how do you strategy against him?
Well, the coach is trying to get me out against him as much as he can. I just I have to pick him up as much as I can in our end, but I think the secret was for the last two games that we played him in their end mostly. I didn't have to check him too close because my two wingers worked really hard in the Islander zone, and it was a big key because from that end there, it's hard for them to get some goals.
Psychologically speaking, your team was down 2-0. Just about everybody had written you off, including the owner of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Mr. DiBartolo. When he declared that he wasn't going to show up for that third game, the first one at home for you, how did the guys feel?
Well, it was something that, you know, we couldn't do anything about, but it didn't do too much to us. All we know, we knew at the time that it didn't matter what anybody said or what anybody did. It's what we did out in the ice that counted. And we made up our minds that we'd work as hard as we could to win the next two games, and we have.
I was told by a Pittsburgh writer, Andre, that the club decided to win it for two people, or two groups, the Pittsburgh fans and for Coach Eddie Johnston. Is that the feeling?
Well, yeah, definitely. All the players are really enjoy the way the management is. Eddie Johnston and our assistant coach are doing a good job, and we want to do it for them, but we also want to do it for us. And the fans were tremendous. They showed up for those two games, and they gave us a lot of support.
Fans in Pittsburgh gave the club a standing ovation several times at the Civic Arena in Pittsburgh, and I am told that that was as much a catalyst for the Penguins as anything, including the message from Mr. DiBartolo of the Pittsburgh Penguins. We'll be back with Andre Saint Laurent, the star of the Penguins, in just a moment. Here at Nassau Coliseum, no score at the end of the first period, and my guest is Andre Saint Laurent, who has been more than superlative for the Pittsburgh Penguins. And Andre, you know a lot of the Islanders. Pat Price, of course, played with the team. That knowledge has to have helped you in this series.
Well, I don't think it has too much to do in the series. It's just a challenge to play against a team like the Islanders. They've won two Stanley Cups in a row, and I don't think being friends with them has nothing to do with what we do out on the ice. We're friends off the ice, on the ice. It's a totally different thing.
Did the fact that the Islanders had taken their luggage with them to the rink, a story that's been going around in Pittsburgh, have any effect on you guys?
Well, I don't know. It might have had an effect on some of the players, but like I said, we were getting ready for that third game. We had to win it. It didn't matter if they bring their luggage or not. For us, it was a must game, and we just worked as hard as we could to win it.
You've seen a lot of good goaltenders in your time. Michel Dion has to be one of the best.
Well, Michel, he was at the All-Star game. I didn't see him for the first part of the season, but must have played tremendous, and he's been the backbone on our squad for the playoff games. He's been playing really well, and we just hope we can take it for two more periods.
Andre Saint Laurent, what is your impression so far of the game? We have had one period, no score.
Well, it's been a pretty close game. The Islanders are taking it to us a little bit, but we're cautious. We're trying to get the puck out as much as we can so that we don't make too many mistakes. When you're out of your zone, you can make mistakes, but they don't cost too much. When you're in your own end and you make too many mistakes, that's where it costs you a game.
We'll be back with Andre Saint Laurent in just a moment. At the end of the first period, and Andre Saint Laurent was, in a sense, restored to life as a hockey player by Eddie Johnston of the Pittsburgh Penguins. He was not being used by the LA Kings, and there must have been a pretty low period in L.A. for you. Never, I'm sure you never dreamed that you'd be right now the center of attention.
Well, no, not this season, not at all. I started off in the American League, and L.A. was having trouble, and they brought me up. And I played pretty well, but then I had some more trouble with my back, and I was in the hospital for 2 weeks in traction. And when I came back, well, they kind of had a different lineup, and they had just decided to put me through waivers. And like I said, Pittsburgh picked me up.
Andre, time and again, people have said that you've been underestimated throughout your career, and we're seeing a perfect example of it tonight and have during this series. Why is that?
Well, I have no idea. I can't say anything about that. All I can say is that, you know, I'm just trying to do my best right now and help my team win the cup.
Okay, now what do you think is going to happen in terms of strategy in the second period? We have no score in this Stanley Cup game, the decisive game. What do you think the strategy is going to be?
Well, I don't know. We're just going to do our best to play in their zone as much as possible. You know, the Islanders have a tremendous team, and they have a lot of scoring power. And it's you got to really cover all their lines, because most of those players can put it in the net.
The feeling has been that the Penguins are relaxed, loose. Nobody expected your club to go this far. Is that the case?
Well, we've been relaxed through the last, I'd say, month of the season. Eddie has let us relax a little bit and enjoy the game and play as good as we could. And we had a little trouble the two first games. We didn't play that well. So that was over with. We just decided we'd just work a little harder, but try not to build too much tension and just do our best out in the ice, really.
Last question. On the strategy, you versus Brian Trottier, how do you manage to get on the ice against him so often, even here at the Coliseum?
Well, all their centers know that if Brian comes out there, their main thing to do is, as soon as the puck's out of our end, is come to the bench so I can get out there.
And you've done it very well. The man on my right, they call him Ace. He has been an ace for the Pittsburgh Penguins, Andre Saint-Laurent, who gave a lot of good service to the New York Islanders, and now he's given the Islanders a lot of headache. We have no score at the end of the first period. We'll be back with more in just a moment.
We're over to see you.
Getting at the Solly talk and saying, Arbour, better look out, that Eddie Burke.
Are they? They're not charging.
Listen, rumor has it now. I don't know that they do something like that, but...
And taping it, too?
And I don't know. Maybe it's going to... We'll find out for sure, but there's a strong rumor around the Coliseum. My spies.
Okay, our group is on its way, then. They'll get you.
The hit gang. They're a happy hit gang. Highlights here in the first period. We have some highlights of the first period. Let's see what they are. That is Rick Kehoe. He's a right winger. He scored the overtime goal for Pittsburgh in the first game. That's Pat Buttet. As they move the puck around, Pat Price. That's Bruce Hood. Here's a shot. Billy Smith has a good beat on it. Makes the save, but he doesn't hang on to the puck. Langevin lugs it out. Bobby Bourne wins a faceoff. I think this is the one where Bob Bourne gets a breakaway. Pat Price is going to make the move right here, keeping Bourne from a breakaway. If he misses right there, you see how close that. If he misses with that, Bourne is in all alone. Price had committed himself. He was off balance. He would have never caught Bourne. He wouldn't catch him anyway. Dion smothers the puck, hauls it in. So we've seen a play at both ends of the ice. Brian Trottier, Randy Carlyle. Trottier has worked hard all period as Bossy moves the puck. Blue line, Potvin, the reason he couldn't shoot, he was off balance trying to get to it. Tonelli, there's the save of the game. That's Tonelli to Bossy. Trottier on the rebound, not to be. Dion stands firm, does not relinquish. Pittsburgh played most of the period in their own end of the ice. 13-4 the shots, that tells you something. Islanders. We'll be back.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just going to say, Islanders played the last half of the period without Stefan Persson. We have no report on an injury or what may have happened to him, so we'll see if he returns for the second period.
We will, Jiggs, and we'll be back for the start of the second period in just a moment. I would not be at all surprised if a left shoulder injury was the reason Stefan did not return. In the Sports Channel Stanley Cup scoreboard, or I should say on the Sports Channel Stanley Cup scoreboard, game 5 at Montreal, Quebec 2, Montreal no score.
Oh my.
The winner of that series,
ooh,
will play the Boston Bruins.
Ooh, 2-0.
If Quebec wins the series, Game one will be in Boston on Thursday. If Montreal wins, it'll be in Montreal. 2-0, Quebec. And here, scoreless between the New York Islanders and the Pittsburgh Penguins as referee Bruce Hood talks with linesman Ron Finn, checks with the goal judges at either end of the ice, with the penalty timekeeper and the man who runs the clock. And we are set for period two. Islanders outshot Pittsburgh 13-4 in the first period. Neither team able to score. Butch Goring centers for Bob Bourne and Bob Nystrom. Andre Salarat will take the faceoff. McClelland to his right, shut to his left. Islander defense suits Foro and Pontan. And the puck comes back to the Pittsburgh zone, picked up by Carlyle. Randy Carlyle, a weak pass, but he still managed to get it into center ice. That's Bob Bourne with it. To Goring. Goring had trouble pulling it around Salarat, cleared it out over the line. It hit shut, and now Carlyle dumps it into the Islander zone. Smith moves back in the net, cutting it off for Potan. Around to the right wing corner for Kenny Morrow. Morrow into center, pulled away from McLeish. Morrow under the stick of Bourne, a backhander, but he couldn't get it away. Ferguson tied him up. Now Ferguson lost it to Morrow, who shot up in the air, knocked down, Goring there, but he couldn't make contact. What's Goring? Around the boards, chasing it is Bourne. Bob Bourne put it out in front, picked off by McLeish. McLeish up on the left side to Bullard. He was checked by Morrow. Morrow, the nice one, the shot went wide. There is Hoffman for Pittsburgh. Hoffman clears it out into center. Off the skate, offside as well at the Pittsburgh blue line. 56 seconds gone in the second period. Close call. Butch Goring grabs the puck out of the air in front of the goaltender Dion, trying to shovel in a backhander. Let's take a look. There he is, number 91, Butch Goring. Morrow's shot just missed. Nystrom, puck is high. There's Goring with it. Pulls it over, tried to shovel it in. The puck would not lay still for him as it ran away from the net. Now Brent Sutter is at center ice. Dwayne Sutter on the right. Clark Gillies on the left side. Back in the Pittsburgh zone. That's nice and faster team that will be fixed. Langevin moves in off the left point to knock it away from McClelland. Gillies to Langevin. It's on the doorstep and cleared by Salarat. Now shot. Sends Salarat into center ice. Salarat at the Islander line trying to come around Langevin and will skate it off the puck. Langevin given a solid hit by Sutter. The blue line, Price with a drive, knocked out in front of the Islander goal and cleared by Brent Sutter to Dwayne, who's flipped it into center ice. This is Gardner. Shot hit Langevin. Langevin tried to play it up left wing. It hit one of the Penguins, came back in. And referee Bruce Hood has called the play. He's got a penalty. Yep. Pittsburgh with too many men on the ice.
That's right, Jakes. Too many men on the ice. Boutette. The puck hit one of the Pittsburgh players as they were changing. Rather close call. Eddie Johnson is really upset. Eddie saying his man was that close to the box. Too many men on the ice called against Pittsburgh at 1:34. It was a close call, though, Jiggs, because the gate was open. Boutette was trying to climb over the boards. The player was coming onto the ice. And Bruce Hood, a lot of the time, the linesman would call that. This time, Bruce Hood, looking right across at the bench, called the penalty.
Bobby Simpson gets off the bench for the first time, comes over to serve the two-minute minor penalty. Former Atlanta Flame, one of their high draft picks. So Trottier, Tonelli, Bossy, McEwen, and Poffin on the Islander power play. Pearson, who would normally be out there, has a bruised shoulder.
How did you know that?
They just gave me a note on it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right.
You called it, AT.
I wonder if it's his left shoulder.
Probably. Price has cleared the puck to center ice. Poffin with it down. Benny Poffin to Bossy. Failed to pick it up. Trottier gave it to Poffin. Benny Poffin across the blue line. Fires it around the boards. In comes Tonelli. Tonelli and Salarat bumped together. Tonelli put it out in front, but Boutette was there. To Baxter. Baxter bumped by Potvin. Now Trache knocks Baxter off his pins. And Trache has it behind the goal. Boutette stuck right with Brian Trache. 40 seconds gone in the power play. Trache up the left side to Tonelli. Dropped it to Potvin. To Brian Trache.
Bache over the Pittsburgh line. The pass to Bossy. Can't get through the defense. Now Bache in the corner. Slips away from Pat Price. Gave it to Bossy. Bossy comes out in front over to Parkman. Then he teed it up. Got it in front. Bossy with it. Bossy comes in deep. Put it out in front. Shot from McClelland. He on the save. Bossy picks up the loose puck. Bossy back to Parkman. Parkman, a drive. Deflected and off the glass. Back to McEwen in the far corner. Back to Parkman. And he shoots. That's part of the goal. Bache chasing it. It'll come out into center ice. Lieutenant Bache get to the Islander line, and back comes McEwen as well. Mike McEwen. The Pape. Now to Bache. 30 seconds left of the power play. Center comes in on the left side. Wayne Center cuts in. Dion makes the save. Carlyle failed to clear it. Bache back to McEwen. Mike McEwen to the right side. Went to the backhand. Turns. Comes in deep. McEwen now to Pape. Parkman, a shot, that's off the target. Ryan Trache into the corner to Denny to Dwayne Sutter to the blue line to McEwen. Over to Parkman. Parkman to Sutter, and the pass failed to work. Sutter back in the goal is checked by Hoffman. Came out in front. There's Trache, shoots on the doorstep. They bang out it. Teams are at six aside, and the Penguins move it up to Simpson. Two on one with Ferguson. Simpson to drive, fifth to save. Brent Sutter picks up the loose puck. Sutter around the boards to Denny Parkman. Parkman at the blue line, into center ice. Over the Pittsburgh line, left side. Brent Sutter moves in around the defense. Backhanded to two in front of the goal. It comes to Gillies. Gillies into the corner. It's in the skates of the referee. Came loose. Sal Alant with it as he had a rest. Dion dumps it into center, down into the Islander zone. Pittsburgh will be called for icing the puck. Islanders unable to cash in the power play. They were all around the net. The Pittsburgh net, Dion again, he is the story, as he has been in the last, well, really, four-plus games, even though he lost 8-1, 7-2 in the first two, he was doing his thing. Now Al Arbour using Butch Goring at center ice, Bob Nystrom on the right wing, Bob Bourne on the left with Lane and Morrow teamed up on defense. Nystrom got a piece of McClelland, and he knocked Bruce Hood into the penalty box. Play is going on, and now Scott, as Hood gets back out of there. No argument from Eddie Johnson and Al Arbour that Hood should have a penalty. He served it quickly. Players did not hear the whistle blow. It continued on a good 20 seconds after the linesman. I believe it was Hodges that blew the whistle to stop the play, but the players didn't hear it. This is Kevin McClelland, Bob Nystrom on him, once, twice. Now watch Bruce Hood, right here. Say goodbye, Bruce, as he serves his time in the sin bin. Well, Goring lines up to take the face off against Salaron. Bullard, Gardner, are their other centers. McLeish can play center, but they're using Salaron a lot. Here's a chance for McClelland, and he blasted it wide. Back to the left point, it's Pat Price around the boards. Ward Lane and McClelland butt together. Bourne picks up the puck, get it out of the reach of Goring. Nystrom chases it at center, into the Pittsburgh zone. Price gets back. Pat Price around the boards, right to Bourne. Bob Bourne into Nystrom, put it out in front, cleared aside by Dion. Here's Nystrom again. Nystrom can't get it to Goring. Laurent clears it out into center. Coming back is Lane. 5 minutes gone in period two. As Nystrom feeds it into the Pittsburgh zone, but right to Dion. Up to McClelland. Lane knocks him down. Chuck has the control. Shot across the line. His shot went off Kenny Morrow. Smith leads it back to the net. Now plays it up the right side for Bob Nystrom. The Butch scoring, unable to control it. Here's Nystrom with it again. Shot was grabbed and got by Dion. Islanders change on the fly. Sends Bullard down the left side, across the Islander line. Bullard slowed up on McEwen's check, but he's really hammered the puck loose at the side of the Islander goal, and Langevin is upended back to the net. There'll be a penalty to Bullard. Bullard for tripping Langevin will give the Islanders their second power play chance of this period.
It's going to catch up with them pretty soon.
A break in the effort.
Mike Bullard, a tripping penalty, the second penalty of the period. Langevin after Bullard right there. Langevin for the puck. Bullard gets the feet of Dave Langevin, and the Islanders are on a power play.
Now McEwen steps in over the line, gave the puck to Trache. Back to Bossy. Gillies goes in front of the net. Bossy couldn't get the puck to him. Mike Bossy back to McEwen.
In the bossy turn, shoots beyond the stick save. It's cleared for Donna. McEwen gives it to Papin. Papin, the pass to McEwen, the dollar whistle. Gillies and Carlyle with the sticks up in the air in front of the Pittsburgh goal. And then Boutette comes over to challenge Gillies. The linesman, Finn, and Hodges get between them. And they both go to the box, both Carlyle and Gillies, that is. Expensive for the Islanders and Gillies, but it's also expensive for Randy Carlyle. Guilty in the first two games of inept play, came back to his game in game three and four. Takes a lot of ice time, goes off with Clark Gillies. Four against three now for the Islanders. Has to be a slight edge again for the Islanders. Five against four. One thing, four against three is just an added advantage. A little more ice to work with.
At 6:02.
Well, it shouldn't be. You get more chances to shoot, Jakes, and the reason is because now instead of a box, the defending team has to go to a triangle. Oh, I see, yeah.
Coincidental penalty.
I'm sorry. Lost my head again.
Well, there's two pages in the rule book.
Gotcha. Backhander didn't get it away, and they can't get it out of the stick of Papin. It was there, but then he couldn't take the puck. Papin to Trache. It's over the Pittsburgh line. Brian Trache moving into the corner. Around Price, out in front, switched it to Park to Tonelli, and he couldn't get a shot away. Comes back to the far side. That's Papin. Papin to Bossy. To Brian Trache. Trache looks for some help. Back to Bossy. Bossy lets it go. Dion is down to make the save, and Sandler tears it right to Papin. Papin over to Tonelli. Tonelli in front. Bossy shoots it on the fly. Bossy picks it up again. Mike Bossy to the blue line for McEwen. The Bossy comes through in front. The drive was blocked. Here's Bossy, another shot. That goes from the glove side. McEwen, the Papin. And it's Papin. He shoots wide of the goal, and Dion dives on top of the puck. What action? Tremendous. John Tonelli in front of the net with Pat Price is a game in itself. The Islanders guilty of missing the net time and time again. How many times do you see Mike Bossy get blocked there and miss the net here? The little things are not working. The times, so many times during the regular season, all of these things were going in the net. Not so tonight. Potvin misses on the last penalty, the bench penalty, too many men on the ice. Dennis Potvin missed three chances to get the shot in on the net. Twice he was low and wide, once over the crossbar. Now 36 seconds left in the penalty to Bullard. The penalties to Gillies and Carlyle do not go up on the board. Coincidental minor penalties. Power play, Islanders are 0 for 4, Pittsburgh 0 for 3 here tonight. The winner advances to play the New York Rangers. If it is Pittsburgh, the series opens at Madison Square Garden. If it is the Islanders, the series opens here. In either case, the Rangers will play on Thursday night. Now Price trying to clear it out. It came back to Papin at the point into Goring. Goring, Goring, and Nystrom. It's Goring to Papin. His shot to the screen was wide. McEwen can't get it in time, and Ferguson has cleared it out. Another missed shot. The opportunities keep slipping through the fingers. Now Denny Papin, left side. Goring had to let it go. He would have been offside. Goring couldn't pick it up, and the Islanders are forced back. McEwen from back of the goal. 5 seconds left in the man advantage. McEwen lucks it out into center ice. Mike McEwen over the Pittsburgh line. That's a shot goal. That was off the target. Goring with it. Back of the net to Bourne. Bob Bourne to the blue line to McEwen. McEwen a shot. Pad save, and Dion covers up on it. Pretty save by Michel Dion. He reaches out with his left pad, and with the pad making the save, we see Bourne here. Leading up to the save. There's the shot by McEwen. Watch the left pad of Dion. He not only stops it, but he hooks it into himself. Puts his hand on it and stops the play. Islanders have a great opportunity. Bullard, they had a bench penalty to Pittsburgh. Bullard got a tripping penalty. Carlyle and Gillies go off. Interference and high sticking, and the Islanders couldn't cash in. Missed the net too many times. They had at least six golden opportunities and missed the net. Now it's Wayne Merrick, Anders Tyler, and Wayne Sutter for the Islanders. Penguins start out led by Hotham.
from into center ice. McLeish pokes it in over the Islander line. Neal into forecheck along with Gardner is out there for Pittsburgh. The puck got away from Chorney at the blue line. That quickly is Hoffman. They've got the two youngsters working together at the moment. And it's paired. Goes down into the Islander zone. Icing way gone. Quarles slapped it around the boards. Right to McLeish. McLeish with a shot. Hit Quarles. Picked up by Gardner. Centered. And it gets away from everybody and out into center ice. Chorney to Hoffman. Them off the boards. Lord Lane has it for the Islanders. Moved it over the line by Merrick. Head out of there quickly to Gardner at center ice. Gardner to McLeish on left wing. McLeish centers. Big save by Bill Smith. There's Baxter with the rebound. That hit Lane. And Gord Lane feeds it to Merrick. Three on one, but they can't make it work. Merrick had a chance to make the play and couldn't handle the puck. Now Merrick drops it to Callow. Callow over to Dwayne Sutter. Sutter shot. Good save by Dion. It was up in the air. McLeish clears it to Gardner on left wing. And in the center ice, that's McEwen for the New York Islanders. Langevin shoots it around the boards. He came off the boards right in front, picked up by Mark Chorney. Chorney out in the center, hit Nystrom, and ricochets into the New York Islanders zone. Back forth, Dave Langevin. Langevin misses Nystrom with a feed. That's going to go the length of the ice, and this will result in an icing call. We have 10:40 remaining, period two, a break in the action, the score tied. 10:42, no score. Fine playoff game, Islanders and Penguins. Ryan Trache is out with Brent Sutter and Bob Bourne as Al Arbour tries another combination. Trache dumped it into the Pittsburgh zone, off the boards. Now Trache is replaced by Nystrom. So Brent Sutter centers for Bourne and Nystrom. Now Laurent flips it high in the air, Nichols into the crowd. Nystrom took a bit of a shot at his old teammate, Sal Laurent. Bobby Nystrom, very physical. He started the game that way. Has continued. Tiring way to play the game. Kind of game Bobby Nystrom can play. There he is. Squeezing Andy St. Laurent into the boards. Brent Sutter comes back for a new stick. He will take the faceoff against Sal Laurent. Ewan and Langevin together on defense. Islanders lost Evan Pearson in the first period, out with a bruised shoulder. Pittsburgh lost Greg Malone in game three, a hip pointer. A player they had counted on through the playoffs, Ron Stackhouse, did not play well. He did have a hip problem, but has been scratched since the first game. Ewan just got a shot away from the blue line, a floater, and Dion had no problem with it. Brent Sutter seemed to have a little problem, however, with Baxter, the defenseman who had grabbed him onto his arm. He'll face off to the left of Dion. Los Angeles and Edmonton in Edmonton tonight. Quebec in Montreal, leading the Canadiens 2-0 at our last report. And here there is no score. The only three games being played. The next round will open on Thursday night. Clark Gillies has scored 11 goals in the 11 games he's played against Pittsburgh this season. Not a bad record. There's been 12 games, but he missed one. Loring got the draw, but he couldn't set up Bourne. Bourne had knocked Baxter's stick away from him. McLeish dumps it out into center ice. That's out of the reach of Ferguson. Coming back is Langevin. Over to McEwen. McEwen to Bob Bourne. In trouble picking it up. Here's Bullard. Bourne checks him. The puck loose, and back goes Bob Bourne. Bourne to McEwen. McEwen, well, he did get it to Goring, but it went off Bullard before it got there. Here's McEwen into center ice. Over the Pittsburgh line, McEwen gave it to Nystrom. Nystrom turned around by Bullard's check. The puck loose. Bourne at the back of the net comes out in front. They score! He takes the rebound and puts it in. The Islanders having trouble. Nystrom was the one that kept the puck in. Here's Bourne as he brings it industriously out in front. Nystrom tucks in the rebound, and it's 1-0 on Bob Nystrom's first playoff goal this season. Nystrom's clearing play into the end. Bourne in front, saved by Dion. Rebound, Bob Nystrom. And it's 1-0.
And we have some debris on the ice, which will result in a delay in getting the faceoff and getting the game underway. Down in the Islander zone to the left of Phil Smith, something has splattered all over the place. Marvelous paper cakes to do that. The Islanders had been on what they call a roll. They had been putting pressure on Pittsburgh. They could have kept that pressure on, but now a lull, a rain delay, if you will, in the action.
I had that at Shea Stadium this afternoon. Were you there? Did you stay during the rain?
Didn't hurt my Mets. Yes, I did. I was right there getting wet until they called it, and we all went inside and dried off. How about that? Met team, huh?
Yeah. They can't win when I'm there, but you go to a ball game and things are great. They're going to win their more than their share, perhaps, but they're going to have an exciting season.
Over 40,000 people there, and they were all enjoying it to the utmost.
And the folks here with Sports Channel get to see those games. 50 of them, well, 48 more during the season. But we have this delay while they clear up the ice. A break in the action. It is 1-0 Islanders. 9:37 left in the middle period. Popham with the puck following the draw. Out of the round of the boards. Backboard is Carlyle. Randy Carlyle able to clear it up left wing to Salerat. Over the Islander line. Andre Salerat trying to come in around Morrow. It was checked, chopped back to the goal, unable to center. The scoring came in on him. Now Salerat one more time. Checked again by Kenny Morrow. And it's loose back to the net, put out in front by Chuck. Carlyle came in, couldn't get there in time, but then did take the man. They freeze it on the boards, and the faceoff will be to the right of Bill Smith.
An exciting game between these two teams. Speaking of Bobby Nystrom and Mr. Clutch, he has 4 career overtime goals, second only to the legendary Maurice Richard in the NHL annals. Richard has 6, Nystrom 4. That's not a bad guy to be only 2 behind.
Oh, I'll tell you what. It's a long list. Not very many will get as close as Bobby Nystrom has.
Pittsburgh started off this period with a bench penalty. Reminds us back to Sunday in the Philadelphia game. Third period, the Rangers had 2 penalties for too many men on the ice and a delay of the game penalty, all in the third period.
Hawthorne has just tied it up for Pittsburgh. Following the draw, a shot from the right point, tipped the stick, flew by Bill Smith, and we are even at 1.
We're all back to where we were a moment ago at 10:18. There's the faceoff. Keyhole back to Hockham. It gets deflected somewhere right there. It's deflected. Billy Smith, look at him. He's moving to his right. The puck is behind him. That's shot, not Keyhole. Shot to Hockham. Deflected inside the left post. The game is back at 1 apiece, or I should say back to tied. It's 1 apiece.
Now Gord Lane from back of his own goal as the Islanders start out. Lane crossed the center ice stripe, dumped it in. Kaller chasing it. Dion out of the net, failed to poke it away. Trotche comes in after it. Ryan Trotche around the boards to Kaller, who slipped the check from Boutette. Anders Kaller to the blue line to Langevin. His shot went wide. Hotham up the boards. McClelland unable to dump it out of there. Tonelli has put it back to the Pittsburgh goal. Carlyle around to the left side, stolen by Kaller. Kaller centers. Tonelli moved in, but it was knocked away from him. Tonelli and McClelland go to the boards together. Both of them without sticks now. And they come up to the boards for a faceoff. McClelland will get credit for the Pittsburgh goal.
And number 27, Rod Schutt.
McClelland's first in the playoffs. Hotham and Schutt on the assists at 11:01 of the second period.
A tip-in goal. You could see Smith playing the original shot by Hotham. McClelland tipped it. Smith could not get back.
Hallway face off to the right of the Pittsburgh goal. Wayne Merrick has come out for the Islanders along with Bob Nystrom and Bob Bourne. Langevin and Gord Lane, the Islander defense. Salerat will take the face off for the Penguins. Not sure about his stick, tapped it on the ice. Didn't sound as if it was broken, so
if that was an all wooden stick, it would be broken. It's got fiberglass on it. Many times the fiberglass will come a little loose somewhere and it rattles away, although the stick is not broken.
You ever expect to see many players with the aluminum shafts that have been...
Have we seen any? I haven't. Don't remember seeing one so far this year. They've had a new element in the game. Aluminum shafted sticks.
A lot of juniors, they tell me, are using them, just as the junior teams and collegiate teams have used a Cooperall girdle and pant like Philadelphia Flyers have used. The Flyers have been eliminated. Buffalo Sabres have been eliminated. Calgary, Minnesota, Winnipeg. Three more teams will be eliminated tonight. McLeish has knocked the puck into the Islander zone. Eric with it from back of the net. Off with the linesman. To Gord Lane. Lane off the boards to Bourne to Nystrom. The play has been called. Ron Finn and outside. A break in the action. The score, the Islanders 1. Pittsburgh. Islanders at home, including the two playoff games. That number or numbers have to change tonight. There has to be a 24 or a 1. Right now, the score is even at 1-1 as Price fed it to the right side. Ferguson is offside at the Islander blue line. Both these teams came in here fired up. If the Islanders outshot Pittsburgh 13-4 in the first period, I would think have a wide margin here in the second as well. They've had Dion performing tricks.
And they should have a lot more, Jigs. They have missed the net numerous times, particularly when they had playoff opportunities. Bobby Nystrom's goal, Bourne got an assist, his 45th Islander playoff point. He passed Jude Drouin for sixth place on the all-time Islander playoff scoring list.
Al Arbour wanted to get Brian Trottier out there for the faceoff. Bruce Hood wouldn't let it happen. And the Penguins move into the Islander zone. It's Ferguson, a shot grabbed by Smith. He covers up on it. There'll be a face-off deep in the Islander zone. Now Bullard gets his stick up back of the net with Wayne Sutter.
That's
about as clear as you can make it, Bruce.
Bruce Hood telling him, stop the leap leap and keep the sticks down.
Senior official. And now the Islanders are sending a hot man, Morrow. Brian Trottier will come out to take the draw in this face-off. For Pittsburgh, it's Laurent, McLeish, and Ferguson. Bullard, who was the center, is replaced by Laurent with the draw in the Islanders' zone. Control of the puck. What both teams are looking for as we watch the face-off. Trottier got the draw to Potvin, around to the right side for Brent Sutter. Brent Sutter to Brian Trottier to Gillies. Gillies dumped it in on Potvin. In to pick it up is Brent Sutter. Brent Sutter played it around behind the net. There's Denny Potvin for the Islanders. Potvin to Brent Sutter. Had trouble picking it up. And McLeish clears it up to Ferguson. Ferguson at center ice. A long rising shot. Smith reached for it and went over top of the net. Brent Sutter with it now. Morrow carries it at center ice, dumps it into the Pittsburgh zone, a bounce right to Dion, who steered it to the corner for a shot. Gillies knocked it away from him, but it went right to Baxter. And Baxter clears it down, right to Will Smith. Now Morrow comes back. 6:34 left in the second period. Out come the Islanders as Potvin relayed it to Denny's, to Dwayne Sutter. Off scoring stick, and Price clears it high and into the New York Islander players' bench. 6:25 remaining in the second period. Nystrom at 10:18. McClelland at 11:01 has been the goal scoring. The crowd, which had been a little quiet after the goal by McClelland, tries to get something going. The New York Islanders.
As we look at Nelson, British Columbia's Pat Price. Now that's Bob Nystrom. We were looking at Pat Price. And Islander first pick back in 1975. Claimed by the Edmonton Oilers in the expansion draft 3 years ago.
Now Goring wins the faceoff. The linesman and shot just went wide on the stick side. McEwen in off the right point. Around the boards to Goring. Price knocked it away from him. There's Baxter for the Penguins. Pulled it away from linesman. Up they come 3-on-2. Baxter over the Islander line. Cuts to the left. The pass to shot. A drive. Stripped the glove save. Ran into Bourne as he cleared it to the corner, but Goring was there. Goring flips it into center ice. The play has been called. It is in and out of the Pittsburgh bench or hit somebody at the bench. They'll face off in the Islander zone to the left of Smith.
Islanders get caught. Al Arbour does not like to see it. What a play Baxter makes as he pulls it around Langevin, comes up the ice. 3-on-2. The shot. Shot. Stopped by Smith. He has trouble again holding on to the puck. Bats it away. From there, it was shot into the Pittsburgh players' bench, and the play was stopped. Vacation begins for one or the other of these teams tonight. Somebody goes on to the quarterfinals. The others go play golf. Rache on the drop. Pittsburgh won the faceoff. Hotham around the boards, intended for Gardner. Gardner lost his balance. Bossy with it. Dropped it back to McKillen. Ewan up the right side to Bossy. Bossy over the Pittsburgh line. Tried to play it in around Carlyle. Bossy with it again. Centered. It's loose. Langevin comes in off the left point. Dave Langevin shots. Here to side by Dion. Tache back in the net. Up the boards. Bossy with it. Back to McEwen. McEwen shot. That sailed high and wide. Tache and Carlyle go to the corner together. Tache trying to tie up Carlyle's stick and handle the puck as well. Trouble doing it. And the Penguins have been able to clear it. Fans yelling for a penalty. Actually, Brian Tache had a hold of Randy Carlyle's stick. Langevin plays them off the boards. Coming back is Satellite. 5:10 left in the second period. The Penguins shoot it down the ice wide of the Alamo goal. Ewan goes back to touch up and we'll get a face-off deep in the
Bank of New York.
Andy Samaras has logged as much ice time as both nets. I don't think he's been off the ice, has he?
Not very often, and not for very long when he does go off. Brett Sutter against Saint Laurent. The draw in the Pittsburgh zone, as you saw, and Baxter plays it to the corner for Price. And Price got it ahead into center ice. This is McClelland, shot with him on the right side. McClelland had the puck knocked away from him by Morrow, and Dwayne Sutter unable to control it. Morrow gave it back to Dwayne Sutter. Got it high in the air into the Pittsburgh zone. Gillies comes in after it. Price beat him to it. Baxter, the shot. Shot. Long drive. Bill Smith, the save. Leaves it for Denny Potvin. And Baxter is down in a heap in the center ice area, getting up slowly as Dwayne Sutter comes over the Pittsburgh line. Dwayne Sutter moving in deep. Goes back to the net, unable to make the play. Potvin and Keogh in the corner. Gardner was there as well. Dwayne Sutter knocked down as he got it to Gillies. Gillies to Dwayne Sutter. Sutter trying to come through in front. Gave it to Morrow. His shot to the screen. The rebound. Dion got in front of the drive from Sutter. Brett Sutter had a crack at the rebound, and Dion robbed him, and now Pittsburgh has iced the puck. All the little things are not going for the Islanders. The rebound right to Sutter. It was rolling. He couldn't get a good shot away. He got it away. There's Gillies. Potvin in deep. Dwayne Sutter comes off the boards. Rink wide pass, shot by Morrow, stopped by Dion. Look at the rebound, wouldn't come out flat, came out bouncing. Price knocks down Sutter. Let's look again at the same shot. Here's Morrow's shot, stopped. Good shot by Morrow. Look at the rebound. Had that laid flat, Brent Sutter would have had no problem putting it in the top of the net, but it was not to be. If you believe in omens, that's not a very good one. All the little things. The Islanders passes, the puck is bouncing. They territorially dominated the play, but they have not been able to get the puck past Michel Dion but one time. Now Kaller, Tonelli, and Merrick for the Islanders. The Penguins cleared it to center off Kaller's stick. There by McLeish to Bullard. He's got a break. Moves in, shoots, he scores! Bullard puts Pittsburgh on top with 16:10 showing on the clock here in the second period. A quick play, the little things, the puck bounces right for Pittsburgh, and Bullard, who was the nemesis of the Islanders all season. Hotham just lets it fly. It hit Kaller on the skate. Bullard end up with the puck. He walked around Mike McEwen and around Billy Smith, and it's 2-1. Pittsburgh, first lead they've had in the hockey game. There's the puck as it bounced off Kaller, goes to Bullard, and Bullard with a fine move scores to give Pittsburgh the lead for the first time in this hockey game. 2-1, Bullard, who scored 7 goals during the regular season against the Islanders. And the Islanders in a hole here, down 2-1, and Bullard hit the puck He had a chance for another partial breakaway. Now he and Morrow into the Islander zone together, but it's taken by Bourne, the pot man. Eddie Potvin, Nystrom coming down the right side, shifts to the left, Potvin over the blue line. Potvin in front to Nystrom, he was upended from behind and never did get a good shot away. Then Goring is bumped off the puck. It comes to Morrow, fanned on his attempt to keep it in at the blue line. McLeish and Bullard there, back came Bourne, and it's Rick McLeish handling the puck. Check by Morrow, of course, is Pittsburgh. They'll go back for it. 3:10 left in the second period. Hoffman from back of his own goal, around the boards. Here's Rick McLeish. The Bullard. Bullard taken up by Morrow. Bourne picked it up at the blue line. Up the middle, and there was Hoffman to break up the pass. McLeish shoots it high. Bourne knocked it down. It was fired right back into the Islander zone. Pittsburgh had half their team on the ice, but the whistle is only for offside. Offside it is. 2 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the second period. Hotham drilled the puck out of his own end. It hit Andy Kaller on the skate. Went to McLeish. He slid it across the ice to Bullard. And he was in all alone after getting around Mike McEwen. And then laid a nice move on Billy Smith. Faking left, going back to the right side. And he tucked it in. His first goal of the playoffs made the score 2-1. Now Langevin backs into his own zone following the drop. Trache is out with Tonelli and Bossy. Bossy takes the pass from McEwen. Handed off Tonelli's stick into the Pittsburgh zone. Trache will get a faceoff to the right of Dion.
You see the fairness in Andy San Laurent. He had Brian Trache at his mercy going in against the boards. He rolled him out of the play where he could have really buried him. It is not his style.
Trache and Salaron on the faceoff. Salaron won the draw from Trache into the corner. It goes. Cleared back of the net by Schutt to Baxter. Baxter up the middle to Salaron. Off his stick to Langevin, who gave it to McEwen. Now to Trache, but a two-line pass. McEwen was about 5 feet back inside the Islander line. Trache was on the Pittsburgh side of the center ice stripe.
Another little thing, Jiggs. All the little things. Islanders can't get them all to go together. The puck bounces. The pass is not on the stick. It's in the skates. The flow is interrupted. When things do not happen in unison.
Bruce Hood like a traffic cop with Eddie Johnson yelling and screaming at him that he has sat through at least three red lights. Johnson trying to make changes. He wanted Gardner out there. Instead, he's going to have to settle for a guy who's seen more than his share of duty tonight, Andre Salaurat, to face off against Trottier. He was trying to get Gardner as the second center. Salaurat was going to stay and do the faceoff honors anyway, but he's not able to get McClelland or Schutt to the bench. Trache on the draw, and he got it back into his own zone, deeper for McEwen. McEwen away from Schutt to Tonelli. John Tonelli gave it to Brian Trache, dumps it in wide of the goal, chasing in Salaurat and Bossy. Bossy put it back to the net. In comes Tonelli, written down by Schutt. Price unable to clear it. Trache ties up McClelland, but Price moves the puck to Schutt. Schutt, a long drive, glove hand save by Bill Smith, who drops it for Dave Langevin. A minute 55 left in the second period. 2-1 Pittsburgh. Out comes McEwen into center. McEwen fires it around the boards. Bossy comes in off left wing. Pick up the puck, put it out in front. Nobody there, and nobody at the blue line. Morrow comes back. In fairness, the Islanders were in the middle of a chain. Morrow checks in his own zone as Gardner stole it. Well, Gardner trying to get it out in front. Carlyle is shot. He scores! Carlyle blasts it by Bill Smith, and Pittsburgh suddenly has themselves a 3-1 lead over the Stanley Cup champs.
A big lead at that by the Pittsburgh Penguins. The captain, Randy Carlyle, from the point. Ken Morrow coughs up the puck at his own end of the ice. The check by Paul Gardner. Used only on power plays, except him. There's the shot. Look at it bounce and weave. It's over the shoulder, the right shoulder, Billy Smith. The score is now 3-1.
Here is McLeish for the Penguins. A long shot from the Islander line was wide. Potvin picks it up. Comes from back of the goal. Denny Potvin to Sutter, and he was belted by Carlyle. Wayne Sutter gets up slowly as the Penguins shoot it back into the Islander zone. Chasing it, Kenny Morrow. Morrow to Potvin. Potvin back to Morrow. Less than a minute remaining in the second period. Morrow comes over the center ice strike. Shot it into the Pittsburgh zone, wide of the net. Carlyle able to clear it. And coming back is Morrow. It did not cross the Islander goal line. Now Pittsburgh in the middle of the player change. Morrow at center ice, the pass to Bourne, who dumps it in. Goring taken out by Baxter. Nystrom in after the puck, gave it to Goring to the blue line. Held in by McEwen, who just got there, lets the shot go into the wide. Poffin from the left point. Into the corner for Goring. First Goring trying to go back to the net. Baxter takes him out of the player. Pat Price rips it ahead off the stick of McClelland into the crowd. 24 seconds remaining in this period. The faceoff is in the Pittsburgh zone, but it's right on the edge of the faceoff circle.
A disciplined team, Pittsburgh. What a turnaround from the first two games. Islanders having problems. It presents a few more problems as the game goes along. Pittsburgh can maintain the two-goal lead, which they should going into the third period. What a boost for their confidence.
Now Goring, Nystrom, and Bourne line up against Laurent, Boutet, and Ferguson of Pittsburgh. Al Arbour has McEwen and Langevin at the points. McEwen will come up high on the right side, so they're playing four across. And Langevin, the lone man at the point. They got the draw to Langevin. His shot went off the stick of Ferguson. Price chases it. Pat Price dumped it out into center ice. Langevin and Boutet collide. Here's a break for Laurent, who's over the Islander line. Can't get around Mike McEwen, and Langevin came back for the puck. Ahead to Bourne, tipped it, but not out. Boutet dumps it into the corner. Going back toward is Langevin, and that will do it for the second period as Langevin dumps it out of there. The horn sounds. The period belongs to the Pittsburgh Penguins as they outscore the Islanders 3-1 in the middle period. Islanders have dominated through about the first 10 minutes, took the lead, but then relinquished that. And the series favors Pittsburgh at the end of two periods in the deciding game. Penguins 3, Islanders 1. Back with a recap following this message. A hockey game. It could be 20 minutes left in an entire season for the New York Islanders or the Pittsburgh Penguins. Right now, the Penguins with a 3-1 lead over the Islanders. This is the amazing part of it. The Islanders dominated the second period, I think had most of their 12 shots by the midway point of the period. Then all of a sudden, Pittsburgh seemed to take over. They scored three unanswered goals after Nystrom had given the Islanders the lead. Everybody who has scored tonight getting their first goal of the playoffs. Nystrom, then McClelland, Bullard, and Carlyle. And the momentum really took a turn by the midway point of that period.
It did, Jiggs, but it really took a turn before then. Some of the things that have not been happening to the Islanders all season are happening tonight. They were happening before, but they weren't as glaring. They were not controlling the puck like they used to. They've missed the net more tonight in the first two periods than I've seen them in so many years miss the net at good chances, at good opportunities. It doesn't mean that every time they shoot the puck, it should go in the net. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is if they put the puck on the net, the rebounds, the kind of rebounds that the goaltender, in this case, Dion, cannot control will be there for the on-rushing forwards, and they're not. And that's hurting the Islanders. It's frustrating them to the point where they're now doing things that they're not usually doing. They're chasing the puck a little bit. It's tiring. It's frustrating. And now they've got to try and, in a 15-minute span between periods, regroup, talk it over, and get all of that back. It's not an easy job. It's a big undertaking.
Pittsburgh doing nothing different tonight than they did at home in the two games. They're taking the man. They're taking advantage of the opportunities as they come up. And they have themselves a 3-1 lead. At the end of two periods, the shots on goal, the totals by the New York Islanders, 25, by the Pittsburgh Penguins, 11. Looking ahead to the third period, the Islanders down by two goals, not out of it by any stretch of the imagination, but things are going to have to become sharper. They're going to have to start beating Pittsburgh to the puck, especially in the Pittsburgh end of the ice.
The magic that the Islanders have had over the past years, Jiggs, is going to be at stake now. And Pittsburgh, on the other side, know ahead of time that they cannot play the rest of this game in their own end of the ice. Sooner or later, that wall that Dion has built in front of the net is going to break down. They can't gamble on that. Are they going to be able to overcome the psychological feeling to protect a two-goal lead in a game that they have not been in since last year? Over a fifth game of a 3 out of 5 series, and that, do they have the experience? Do they have all of the things it takes to be able to hold off an Islander team?
Well, we'll find out with 20 minutes of hockey remaining at the end of two. Our score, the Pittsburgh Penguins 3, the New York Islanders 1. Bill Busey, sports writer, columnist with the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette, will be along with Stan Fischler when we return to the Coliseum following this message.
Stan Fischler here at Nassau Coliseum at the end of the second period. The Penguins 3, the Islanders 1. My guest, Phil Music, columnist of the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette. And Phil, when we talked about a week and a half ago, I don't think you or I in our wildest dreams would have imagined that the series would have been at this point.
Tremendous fantasy, Stanley. I think it's amazing. It surprises me.
How do you figure it?
I don't, other than maybe the odds. They've played 25 games here without a loss. They come in tonight against a team that has gotten a little momentum after the weekend series in Pittsburgh, and fate, maybe.
What about the coaching of Eddie Johnston? You've been able to study him for a couple of years. What has he done to this Penguin team?
He's given him some discipline, Stan. I think he came to Pittsburgh from Chicago with a reputation as a man who had a system. He was a pattern hockey man. And he put it in and suffered through the first problems last year, a big fade in, midway in the season. This year they've struggled a good bit of the season, finished fourth in the division. I think maybe the players are beginning to believe in Eddie Johnston's style of hockey, and it's certainly come through like a dream here tonight and through the series.
Phil Music, you've covered all the major sports, baseball, football. Have you ever seen a turnaround the way this series has gone? Now, the Penguins were shellacked here, two straight games, and now they're leading 3-1 in the decisive fifth game in any sport, baseball, football, basketball.
I don't think so, Stan, in the sense that when the Penguins came into this building and lost the first two games, they lost them decisively. They were embarrassed. Then to come back in Pittsburgh, you might have expected one win on true grit, if nothing else. But I've never seen a team with an imbalance of talent that exists in a series like this. The Islanders, far and away, a more talented hockey team. No, I've never seen anything quite like it.
So much has been made of the statement made by the owner of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Mr. DeBartolo, about being embarrassed, not wanting to show up for the first game in Pittsburgh. Now, some people in the league think he should be censured for what he said. What's your feeling?
I kind of liked it. It reminded me of the time that Ray Kroc in San Diego picked up the PA system and blasted the Padres on the field. I think if a man's put a lot of money into a franchise, he's been frustrated by this team time and time again. He's got a history in many other businesses of being successful. Now he's angry and he's embarrassed. And I thought it was kind of neat. I don't know how they'd go about censoring him. I guess the Board of Governors would have a way. But it seemed to me that would be a little stuffed shirt. I liked it.
Phil Music, what effect did that have on the Penguins?
Oh, I think the idea that it had some dramatic effect was overdone. They were a little irritated, some of the veteran players. I think Randy Carlyle was a bit outspoken. He said, man signs the checks, he has a right to say whatever he wants. They were a little bit, felt publicly chastised, but I don't think anybody lost any real sleep over it.
Okay, we'll be back with Phil Music of the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette in just a moment. We're here at Nassau Coliseum, the Penguins leading 3-1 at the end of the second period. My guest is Phil Music, columnist with the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette. And Phil, we are witnessing one of the truly superb exhibitions of goaltending, Michel Dion. What do you know about him? What kind of guy is he?
Most of what I know about him, you told me, if you remember. Nice young kid. Seems intense, like many goalkeepers. Very serious. Pretty well-spoken young man, and he's been sensational.
He has also benefited from the coach, who also was a great goaltender, Eddie Johnston. He's had to have helped him.
No question. He acknowledges that publicly. When he came to Pittsburgh, he was a little unsettled, I think, personally. Found out he had a kindred spirit in Johnston, and Eddie worked with him. I saw him working with him a lot during camp. EJ was a fine goaltender in his own right, and it certainly has to have helped him.
Phil Music, the play of the Penguins, particularly the last two games and tonight, has to be a tonic for professional hockey in Pittsburgh. Now, those of us who've watched the league have always wondered, you know, is Pittsburgh a good hockey town? What will this series do for Pittsburgh as a hockey town?
That's an interesting question, Stan. There was a theory in Pittsburgh by people who enjoy hockey or the media that what the Penguins best needed in a series like this was to be blown out in three straight games, and then there would be no illusions. They used an advertising slogan, "We have a hockey team." Well, the general theory until this series was, no, we don't have a hockey team, or we have a hockey team, question mark. Now it can't, if they can hang on and win tonight, it's got to do terrific, have terrific benefits in ticket sales. The customers will enjoy this. They haven't, they were a little disappointed last year when they played well against St. Louis, lost in overtime of the fifth game and were bumped out. This, I think, would hype hockey in Pittsburgh, especially if they could go then into the quarterfinals and do what they wanted to do in this series, which was to play respectable hockey. Now, if they can do that against the Rangers, it could turn the corner in Pittsburgh.
Last question before you go. What sort of Pittsburgh team will it be next year? Do you know for a fact that Eddie Johnson is going to go for more youth?
Oh, I don't think there's much question in that. There's, a general theory that some veteran players will not be back, that a Ferguson will not be back, that a Ron Stackhouse, who is not dressed in this game, won't be back, and there may be a couple of others. I think he's going to have to go with the kids. There's some feeling in their locker room that they should have gone with their young players earlier in the year.
One guy I think will be back, and that's Andy St. Laurent.
No question. Great bargain, $7,500.
He's done some job. Andy St. Laurent, of course, a former Islander, has played absolutely sensational defensive hockey. He's been taking Brian Trottier and had a wonderful night so far for himself. We'll be back in just a moment.
And before, the only thing they have to be careful of is you have to do a lot in a situation like this, but you try to do too much, and it kills the game. Kills the game for them.
Over two periods, Mike Bossy has had five shots on goal. Mike McEwen has had five. Bob Anamoro each with three. Bourne, Nystrom, and Tonelli each have had two shots on goal. The only Islander goal, that by Bob Nystrom. And the third period is underway. Trottier, Bossy, and Tonelli. Here's Poffin. Backhanding it into the Pittsburgh zone. St. Laurent chasing it. Andre St. Laurent taken up by Trottier. Bossy with the puck. Put it off to the side of that. It was cleared by Dion. Trottier back in the goal to Tonelli. Checked by Carlyle. Now Tonelli got it loose. Trottier slips away from the check. Comes out in front. Dion the save. The puck loose. Bossy trying to center. Comes back to Morrow. Morrow turns and shot to a screen. Tipped and cleared aside. Dion, an excellent save. Ryan Trottier sets up Tonelli. And Dion makes the stop on him. Dives on top of it and forces a faceoff.
Andy St. Laurent takes Mike Bossy down behind the net. Bossy gets up slowly. Bruce Hood is not likely to call a penalty. Here's the puck in front. Bossy checks Dion out in front. Right here, Morrow can't get the puck around quick enough, but he gets a pass on it. He doesn't get a shot. Tip wide by Bossy.
The Islanders come out storming. Here's more of the action. Tonelli. Dion, that stop, and then he all on top of it. In the first period at Edmonton, Los Angeles leads Edmonton Oilers 2-1. Gretzky has scored for Edmonton. Charlie Simmer had one of the LA goals. Both of them, I believe. Yes, both for Simmer. For the Islanders now, it's Brent Sutter, Clark Gillies, and Dwayne Sutter. The Penguins into the Islanders zone offside as McClelland led the rush, but Chuck was in ahead of them. 45 seconds gone in the final period.
Rod Shutt, Bancroft, Ontario, he's 25. He's come on strong in the last three games. He was Montreal's second pick in 76. Came to Pittsburgh for their first round pick in the 81 entry draft, who was Mark Hunter.
St. Laurent against Brent Sutter. He got the draw to Gillies and to McEwen. Mike McEwen carries it up the middle. Long shot from center ice. Dion the stick save, and the puck went into the crowd.
One of the little things, Jiggs, you just saw Mike McEwen take the puck, skate straight up the ice. The forwards were coming back, making a turn, looking for a pass. They wanted to come up together. McEwen dashes up the ice, takes a shot from outside the blue line, and the closest forward was Clark Gillies, who had just crossed the red line. That's the little things. You got to get that together. McEwen, rather than should have waited. Wait till the forwards make the complete turn, and then they all come up together.
Now Al Arbour sending out Goring, Bourne, and Nystrom. Poffin and Morrow are out on the Islander defense. Islanders started the game without Marini, Janssen, and Greg Gilbert, and have lost the services of defenseman Stefan Persson with a bruised shoulder in this game. Goring against St. Laurent. Bourne moved in, knocked McClelland down. Pat Price has the puck.
Rice playing it up the left side, out of the reach of Shutt. Loose in the Islanders' zone. Smith had to play it away from Shutt, who had lost his balance. Here's Morrow. To Nystrom. To Goring. Goring across the blue line. A drive. Glove save by Dion. Held it, then dropped it for Price. That Price gets away from Bourne. The Pittsburgh line. Price comes to center ice. Dumps it in wide of the net. Bill Smith has to meet it. Morrow knocks it away from Bullard to Poppin. Up the left side to Bourne. Right wing to Nystrom. Three Penguins back. Nystrom trying to pull wide. He's in on his off wing around Carlyle. Poked it away from Ferguson as well, but Hoffman gets back. Hoffman checked by Nystrom. Carlyle able to pick up the loose puck. Gave it to McLeish. McLeish rink wide to Ferguson. George Ferguson at the Islander line. Slowed up by Tonelli. Ferguson controls it again. It was checked. It's loose for McEwen. Mike McEwen around the puck end. First 2 minutes are gone here in the final period. Poppin up to Brian Trottier. It was checked. It came back to Denny Poppin. He leads the rush into center ice to the Pittsburgh line. His pass is deflected and goes in offside. Dennis Poppin led the team in shots on goal coming into the hockey game, but does not have anything to show for it. He does not have a point in 4 games and 2 periods. You wonder, coming into this series, just how bad his back was, how bad Mike Bossy's knee was, and assorted other hurts and aches and pains, but everybody plays with aches and pains.
Exactly, Jiggs. That's not something any of the players would ever look back on and say was a reason for them not being successful, whether it be Pittsburgh or the Islanders.
Right now, the guy that is beating them is Michel Dion. McEwen carries the puck up the middle. Mike McEwen flips it into the Pittsburgh zone. Trottier goes in after. He and Carlyle get there together. Tonelli comes in on the opposite side. Took it back to the net, trying to get it away from Carlyle. Now Trottier is tied up by Sadalot. Carlyle comes over and clears it. Held in by McEwen. To Bossy. He was ridden off the puck by Carlyle. And out at center ice, this is McClelland one-on-one with Langevin. McClelland is checked. Langevin went to the boards. The puck tipped behind the Islander goal. Up comes Trottier. Trottier put it right on the stick of Bullard. Smith the pad save.
What a save by Billy Smith. An errant pass inside the blue line by Brian Trottier. Billy Smith saves them.
And that is a rare moment in itself to see Trottier give the puck away like that. Now Pittsburgh has dumped it down the boards into the Islander zone. Lane touches up, and that's an icing call. A break of Lane, and it's tipped out of the center ice. Tony Morrow hustles back. Pittsburgh making a player change. Morrow fed it to Lane. Long pass, intended as a long pass at least, went off his stick. Now Gord Lane steps around McLeish. The pass to Goring, off his stick to Nystrom, who was poked away by Gardner. Morrow is back. 4 minutes gone in the final period. Morrow to Trottier. Trottier from the blue line, and it sailed over top of the net. Andy Carlyle, the Pittsburgh captain, played it around the boards. Protect couldn't hold it. Here's McEwen coming in. Lost control of the puck, and it comes up to center ice. Trottier has it there. Now to Langevin. Dave Langevin, a long shot. Wide. McEwen pulled it away from Sadalot. Gave it to Gillies. Clark Gillies, a drive. It's Clark Trottier, the rebound. Langevin shooting it into the Pittsburgh zone. Dion cuts it off. Price to the left side for Shutt. And Shutt rolled it outside the zone blue line. Dwayne Sutter drops it for Langevin. Up the middle, offside, delayed at the Pittsburgh line. McEwen has the puck at center ice and shoots it in. Islanders making a complete change. Brent Sutter comes out with Merrick and Keller as the forward line. There's McClelland to Carlyle at Pittsburgh. Brent Sutter ran into him. Gardner slaps it around the boards in the Islander territory. We played the first 5 minutes of the final period. It is still 3-1 Pittsburgh. Keller, right wing to Brent Sutter. Sutter fires it into the Penguins' zone. Dion on the boards, intended for Boutet. Brent Sutter knocked it away from him. The pop up in the corner, and there's no further play.
What a play by Randy Carlyle off Brian Trottier. Trottier had the open net. Carlyle got his stick in front of the puck. Take a look at the play. The Islanders all over Pittsburgh. Clark Gillies blasts it. Stopped by guess who? Dion. There's the open net. There's Trottier. And as he tried to shoot it, Randy Carlyle got to him quickly. Usually it's Andre Saint Laurent getting to him. That time Carlyle picked it up. Rides Brache out of the play after checking him.
14 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in regulation time. Wayne Merrick moves to the right. Brent Sutter comes in to take the faceoff against Saint Laurent. Brent got the draw. Back to Morrow. Morrow's shot went wide. McClelland picks it up on the right wing board. McClelland at center ice. Long shot wide of the Islander goal. Backboard is ball. Played it away from Shutt to Brent Sutter. Up the boards to Merrick. McClelland steps into him and the puck went to Price. That Price. Brent Sutter knocked him off the puck. McClelland was there to back up the Pittsburgh defenseman. McClelland played it out to center. Poppan shoots it into the Pittsburgh zone. Dion went back to the net. Weapon for Price. Around to McLeish. Rick McLeish checked by Morrow. Brent Sutter moves in, but the Penguins come out 2-on-1. Keller catches up as the pass to McClelland went astray. Now he steps around Poppan. McClelland down on one knee. Lost the puck to Merrick. Wayne Merrick into center ice. They move up 3-on-3. Merrick, Keller, and Bossy across the line. And the pass broken up by Bullard. McLeish trying to come into the Islander zone. Langevin beats him to the puck. Head to Lane. Marty Lane moves up the right side into center ice. Lane stick handling. Lost it. Now shoots it in off Ferguson. Bossy in. Can't pick it up. It's cleared to center ice. Langevin is there. Langevin over to John Tonelli. Tonelli works it around the boards. Dion slowed it up. Bossy comes in after it. Carlyle beat him to it. Carlyle to Ferguson. Tonelli runs him into the boards. The puck went to Bossy in front. Touch a check. Tonelli with that puck. A place for Pittsburgh. To Saint Laurent, who's knocked away from him. Held in, but they roll outside as Bossy came over the blue line. 13. Now Goring centers for Bourne and Nystrom with Morrow and Potvin on defense. Randy Carlyle coming out for the Penguins. Dumps it high into the Islander zone and right to Bill Smith. Dropped it off for Potvin. Poffan fed it to Nystrom in around the check of McLeish. Nystrom cuts in, shoots Dion, the save. Michel Dion moved to his left up the top of the goal mouth, or the goal crease at least, and made the stop off Nystrom. Quick pass by Dennis Poffan. Springs Bob Nystrom. Here's Poffan through center ice, spots Nystrom on the right side. As he steps around, Rick McLeish comes in, takes the shot. Dion well out of the net, cutting down the angle, makes the save. Off the on-rushing Bob Nystrom. Nystrom with the Islanders' only goal. He got it at 10:18 in the second period. And it was three straight goals. McClelland, Bullard, and Carlyle for Pittsburgh. Islanders get the draw here, but Poffan's shot goes off Ferguson and into the crowd. A little more pushing and shoving after the whistle, but they'll line up for a faceoff inside the Pittsburgh blue line.
Dennis Poffan not getting the puck away quick enough. Deflected. That's what the defender wants to do. That half a step, he wants to reach out, get his stick in the way, break up the shot, whether it be a pass or a shot at the net.
We haven't had a penalty called since 6:02 of the second period. All the goals came while the teams had six aside following that point. Nystrom knocked the puck down at the Pittsburgh line. Got it to Goring. The form comes in on left wing. His shot. Dion juggled it. And it's cleared by Bullard. McLeish picks it up. And there'll be a penalty call coming up as Poffan chases it back in the Islanders' zone. Pittsburgh training staff is being called out on the ice. Nystrom knocked Dion down in the goal mouth. And the Islanders are going to be penalized here. Nystrom upset with referee Bruce Hood. Claiming he was pushed into the goaltender, I would think. But the Islanders draw the first penalty. Nystrom for charging. I say first.
And it draws the first penalty of the third period. A charging penalty. He worked hard to keep the puck in to Goring. Goring swats it to Bob Bourne. He shoots. Puck is loose. There it is, dribbling down. Dion went down to stop it. Bullard knocked it away, and Bobby Nystrom slid in. That, I don't agree with that call. Nystrom was on his way to the net, slid into him backwards, and Dion went down heavily.
He got a push from one of the Penguins, too. He was shot.
May we take another look at that if they still have it, as Bob Nystrom slides into the goaltender. The intensity of the game allows this. Watch here as Bob Bourne lets the shot go. Watch in front of the net. It's stopped and the puck is loose. It's a loose puck. It's fair game. That's Bullard right there. Nystrom's momentum carried him into the goaltender. He was backwards when he ran in to goaltender Michel Dion. He did not go straight in. Bruce Hood has called a charging penalty on Bob Nystrom. First of all, the puck was loose at the net. And secondly, Nystrom went in backwards. Unusual call. All the little things again.
It is Dion's catching hand or arm that is bothering him, but they... Pittsburgh trainer Steve Thomas satisfied that he is okay and will get a faceoff out in the center ice area. But Nystrom is in the penalty box for charging. It's called at 7:31. 12:29 remaining in this hockey game. Regulation time. Pittsburgh leading 3-1. Now Billy Carroll out to scoring. Carroll forced it away from Hotham, but Carlyle comes out of the far corner. Ahead to Keogh, to Gardner, who failed to pick it up. Linesman for the Islanders to Billy Carroll. Lost it to Hotham. Out at center ice, and a two-line pass called against Pittsburgh.
Islanders haven't scored a shorthanded goal in some time. Maybe now is the time to do it. It's the time the fans all sitting on the edge of their seats waiting for something to happen. That's what they're looking for. Something to get a spark, get things going. Islanders have played pretty good in some areas. Some players, not all. They need everybody.
On the draw, the Penguins control it. Hotham back of the net to Carlyle. Randy Carlyle dumps it out into center ice. Langevin has it. Gave it to Morrow. A minute and a half left in the Pittsburgh power play as Morrow sends the Penguins back. Boutet, Gardner, and Keogh as the forwards. Carlyle has pulled it away from Bourne, got it away from Keller, then is chased back by Bourne. And Carlyle dumped it off the boards blindly right to Keller. And there's Keller turning. And Bourne on left wing. Trying to come in around Hotham, does right in. Shoots off. Shot into the glove of Dion. He fed it off to the corner. Keller knocked it loose. There is Carlyle for Pittsburgh. Randy Carlyle goes down the play a little and just did get it away from Keller with his pass for Gardner. Gardner shoots it around the boards on the left side. That's Keogh coming in. Lost control of it. Borrow for the Islanders. Off the boards, up the left side for Anders Keller. Keller pulled it away from McLeish, gave it to Goring. Goring crossed the Pittsburgh line, trying to come in around Carlyle, put on the brakes. Goring unable to make the play, however, and here is Gardner. All Gardner at the Islander line. Dropped it to McLeish. McLeish centering attempt, hit Billy Carroll on the head. McLeish now to the blue line. That's Baxter with a drive. Smith the save, and he covers up. Gardner was right there in front of the net, but Bill Smith came up with a key save for the New York Islanders. 18 seconds left in Nystrom's penalty.
Islanders had to gamble a little. They did. Dave Langevin gets caught up the ice. Pittsburgh comes back, gets a play at Billy Smith on the net. Here's the play by Bob Bourne. What a save here by Dion. This is a big save right here. Good play by Bourne. The shot is on the net. His left catching glove, or his glove on the left hand, gets just enough of the puck to deflect it wide. The little things again. So often we've seen that shot go in the net.
Ryan Trotsche to face off for the Islanders against Bullard. Trotsche got the draw in the lane, who comes back to the net. After Goring, third up, but not up. This is Ferguson, his shot off Poffin and into the corner. There's Bullard, back of the net from McLeish. McLeish chased to the corner by Poffin. Poffin knocked it away from McLeish, and back goes Baxter with Nystrom out on the ice again. 10:25 left in regulation time. Pittsburgh with a two-goal lead. And Price, but a long pass out of the reach of Satterlund. Here's Lane at the Islander line to Poffin. And he Poffin sends Tonelli over the Pittsburgh line. Comes in around Ferguson, but then is chased wide by Carlyle. Knocked down. Tonelli trying to get back to his skates. Carlyle knocked him down a second time. Trotsche with the puck into the corner, but there's Satterlund. Headed right to Trotsche. Forehand by and shoots. The save by Dion. Rebound. And it comes out on the right side. Cleared. Held in by Poffin. Poffin. Checked by Schott. Managed to get it to the corner. Hotham was there. Headed it to Poffin. Over to Tonelli. And he couldn't hold the pass. John Tonelli. Up to Nystrom. Nystrom turns. Shoots Dion. The save. The rebound was wide. Tonelli picks it up. Gives it to Poffin. Dennis into the corner. Tonelli at the side of the net with two out covered. Ferguson dumps it to center, and here's a break. Down right wing comes Schott. Schott with a shot. Wide on the glove side, and it bounces to center. Nystrom takes it there. Gave it to Brian Trotsche. Trotsche got it to the Pittsburgh line. The Penguins cleared back into center ice. 9:18 left. McEwen to Langevin. He shoots one around the boards in the Pittsburgh zone. Got away from Dion. Schott slapping at it. It was knocked down right at the line by McEwen, but then he couldn't hold it. McEwen at center ice loses control of it. Bullard on left wing, a slap shot was wide. Ricochets into center ice. Baxter goes back. Gave it to Price. And Price bumps it ahead. Lafleche leads it back into his own zone to Baxter. Baxter to target to center. Got away from McEwen, and the Islanders have to go back. We have less than 9 minutes remaining in regulation time. Here's McEwen. McEwen sends Brent Sutter to the Pittsburgh zone. He fired it around the boards. Wayne Sutter in to pick it up. It came off his stick. Carlyle knocked it down. Played it to the boards. McEwen with it. But Brent Sutter couldn't control it. Out comes Kehoe. Kehoe handed it to McEwen at center ice. Boutette poked it away from McEwen, but Brent Sutter now sends Wayne down the right wing. Carlyle got back in time. He gave it to number 20. That's Gardner with a backhand shot. It drops it for Langevin. Dave Langevin to Kenny Morrow. Morrow carries it to center ice. Guided around the boards in the Pittsburgh zone. In quickly comes Doring. The Bourne back of the goal. He was checked by Price. Price trying to get a faceoff, and he succeeds.
Dan Laurent tries to clear it unsuccessfully. Right on the stick of Trache. He goes in, lets the shot go. He didn't get much on it, but there was a lot of bodies in front. The puck doesn't stay in front of the net. It's cleared.
Now as we get underway again, it's McClelland at center ice, shooting it into the Islanders zone. That's Bossy back around the board. Bossy, Boring, and Bourne. Bossy fed it to Boring, I should say, fed it to Bossy on right wing. Leon back to the Pittsburgh goal, into the corner. That's Bossy. It came back to Morrow. Morrow around the boards. Come to the Islanders, able to make contact with it. Pop pass from the point. A shot went off Bossy's stick. Bossy put it out in front. Bourne can't get a stick on it. Out comes Price. Price, left side to shot. Got inside the Islander zone. Tried to feed it into McClelland. Popham played it away from him. On board. Back to the Islander captain, Denny Popham. Popham ahead to Trache. Trache slips around McLeish into center ice. Over the Pittsburgh line. Trache trying to come in around Carlyle. Right at the front of the net. He was out there. There's going to be a penalty to Carlyle. Trache slid into Dion, knocking him out of the goal.
A power play coming up. Trache, speed down the right wing side as he gets around Carlyle partially. Carlyle goes after Trache, right here, reaches over and hooks him off his feet as he slides into Dion. He gets a penalty. Islanders have to score on this power play. Imperative.
Laffan at the left point, McEwen at the right. Brian Trache, Anders Kaller, and Clark Gillies. The forward line, Salarant won the faceoff. Baxter has taken off the puck. Trache was tripped by Salarant. Got the puck back to Popham. A drive through a screen, and it just went wide. McEwen in off the right point. Checked by Pat Boutette, who clears it off Gillies and down into the Islander zone. Popham chases it. Pittsburgh makes some changes. Eddie Johnson has Boutette and Ferguson up front. As Popham starts out. At the pass to Keller, it breaks in, trying to come around twice. A backhander is blocked. Cleared by Ferguson up the right wing boards. Here's a break for Boutette. McEwen hustling back. Boutette cuts to the left side. Left it for Ferguson. He shoots. Smith the save. Bill Smith. Everybody skated away from it. Now Trache picks it up. Ryan Trache into center ice. A minute 15 left in the power play as he sent Tonelli over the line. Ron Tonelli goes back to the net. Lost it to Baxter. Baxter around the boards. And it'll come to center ice down into the Islander zone. Making changes as Popham picks up the puck. Eddie Popham, right side to Butch Goring. Goring at the blue line. Dick handles his way into center ice. Left it between the Penguin defense. Chorney is there, slaps one off the boards, and it ricochets into the Pittsburgh players' bench. 46 seconds left in this power play that hasn't really produced much in the way of a scoring attempt.
Running around, Jiggs, the Islanders trying too hard. They get away from the pattern that was successful all season long. Right here, Pat Boutette drops the puck to number 11, Ferguson. Billy Smith, good save by Billy Smith on a shot by Ferguson. Islanders doing the unusual again.
And the unusual now will give them a rest. It'll give Al Arbour a chance to talk to everybody. He's going to send Roland Melanson into goal. But this is just, I think, and looking ahead, this is just for one shift. Maybe one whistle, and he'll get Bill Smith up. But what he is getting now is a rest for his team.
Exactly.
Because they can warm up Roland Melanson.
Good call.
Angles back to the net. Bossy came in to pick it up. Bossy back to Poppin. Off his shin pad, and he'll have to bring it out into center ice. Poppin to Gillies. Gillies across the Pittsburgh line. Taken out by Baxter. Bossy fed the puck to Poppin. To McEwen, comes in on the right side. McEwen, the crunchy, checked. Bossy with a shot. Head save. The rebound is good.
Checked by San Laurent, a shot on goal by Bossy. Rebound, that's how they get him. McEwen, who is actually out of position, but who cares? He started the play. Here he comes as he drops the puck. Shot by Bossy. McEwen, that's the right thing. He goes to the front. Krejci covers the point. And Mike McEwen has brought the Islanders within one goal of the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Bill Smith comes back into goal, replacing Melanson.
23 seconds, Jiggs, after Al Arbour switched goaltenders. The Islanders score a goal.
Islanders now, that was his second of the playoffs.
Mike McEwen's second playoff goal at 14:33 has pulled the Islanders to within a goal of a tie. I'm Jiggs McDonald with Ed Westfall. Bossy and Krejci assisted on McEwen's goal. So we have 5:27 remaining. Games are at 6 aside. The goal came with Carlyle in the penalty box. Hoffman gave the puck to Carlyle. Shot now. Backhanding it down into the Islanders' zone. Poppin picks it up. Tonelli wheels up left wing. Poppin carries it into center ice. Kenny Poppin over the Pittsburgh line. Winds up. Shoots Dion the save. The rebound went to Ferguson. He cleared it out into center ice, and Goring comes back. He gave the puck to Morrow. All with 5 minutes left. Has to go deep, trying to get away from McLeish. Grounds the Islander net and turns. Pittsburgh sends Ferguson into forecheck with Bullard. Hoffman up the left wing. Goring couldn't take the pass, and here is Hoffman with it. To Ferguson. Ferguson slipped it over to Bullard. Bullard around Morrow. Shot fit the save. The rebound, and McLeish couldn't get there. Nystrom breaks out. Nystrom into center ice. Over the Pittsburgh line. Lost control of the puck, and it's cleared to center. Coming back is Dave Langevin. 4.5 minutes to play. Langevin to McEwen. Now to Langevin. Langevin down the left side. Shot it in off Nystrom. It rolled right to Dion. Left it there for Price. Up the near side. This is Bullard. And McClelland comes to the Islander line and shot in by McClelland. Smith unable to cut it off. Gillies has it on the right wing. Achilles to McEwen, slipped around the check, another check, in the center ice, 2-on-2, McEwen across the line, he's shooting, Dion the save, and the rebound went wide, as it was cleared in, out comes McClelland, McClelland at the Islander line, a slap shot, Bill Smith the save, Langevin back for it, to Mike McEwen, McEwen sends Krejci in the center ice, Krejci, right into the check to San Laurent, Krejci back with his skate, slipped it over to Bossy, but San Laurent was there, 3 minutes and 42 seconds left. Gillies dumps one into the Pittsburgh zone. Carlyle hustles back for it. Randy Carlyle at center ice. In the Islander line, trotted it in around the board. Smith cuts it off. Ward Lane has it. Lost it, picks it up again. Best hand on it, and so did Boutet, fortunately for the Islanders. Bossy starts out on the right side. The pass to Merrick. Merrick over the Pittsburgh blue line. Drop pass. Boren can't pick it up. Here's the finish. McLeish coming back. Into the center ice zone. McLeish tries a long shot. Oh, that was shoulder high. And Smith had to reach up for it. The ball. Not the ball. Carroll moves into the middle. Takes a breaking pass. Around Baxter. Cuts in. Shoots. Dion the save. But the whistle had sounded. I believe the whistle had sounded a while ago. 2:58 left. Offside on the pass. The faceoff in the Islanders' zone.
How close can you come? Inches. The game is inches. Here's Bob Bourne. He makes the pass. It was an offside pass. The player wasn't offside at the blue line. It must have been two lines. Keller takes the shot. stop by Dion. Keep the tape going. There's two saves by Dion. The players didn't hear the whistle. There's the pass. He called it a two-line pass. There's two saves on the play. Keller, as he goes by Baxter, gets the shot away. Good save. Dion in the rebound. Here's the rebound. Look at the save Dion makes off Wayne Merrick. Whether the whistle had blown or not, the players didn't know it.
2:58 left. Offside pass. The call. The faceoff in the Islander zone. Merrick centering for Bourne and counter. Lane with the puck. Ward Lane up to Bob Bourne. Bourne on the boards. Check. Salaron dumps it in wide of Phil Smith. There is Morrow back. Andy Morrow clears it out into center ice. McClelland takes it for Pittsburgh. Ridden off the puck. Now picks it up again and dumps it into the Islander zone. We have 2:40 remaining. Ward Lane trying to get away from shot. Dragged down. Or did he die? There is no whistle in any event, and here comes Lane. Lane at center, a long shot wide of the net. Tonelli in after, off the stick of Carlyle. Tonelli scores! John Tonelli has tied the game! Carlyle lost the puck, and John Tonelli rifles it home with 2 minutes and 21 seconds left. Oh, my! What a comeback for the Islanders, but it ain't over yet, folks. They're out. They've done it time and again. They've done it again. John Tonelli, he was the guy that scored the goal to keep the team alive and make it 15 straight as Gordy Lane clears the puck in. Carlyle misses the puck. It bounced over his stick. The first bounce that the Islanders have gotten all game. And John Tonelli has put the puck in the lower right-hand corner. Gordy Lane starts the play. It's a fluke bounce. The Islanders haven't had a break all game, and there's the first break. John Tonelli, the opportunist all season, gives the Islanders a 3-3 tie. How exciting can you make it?
Eddie Morrow and Gord Lane get assists, 17:39 of the third period. If there's the story, 3-3 tie. I didn't realize it was almost 11 o'clock.
It is. If you ask 15,000 people in this building, are the Islanders going to pull it out? They'd have said no. And 100 would have said maybe. But they have at least tied the score. A reprieve. The fans are going crazy here in the Nassau Coliseum. They have done it before. John Tonelli scored a goal with only seconds remaining against Glenn Rush to give the Islanders 15 straight wins. And he has now scored a goal here to give them a 3-3 tie and keep the game alive.
We have 2 minutes and 21 seconds left in regulation time. The ice has been cleared of debris and we're set to go as referee Bruce Hood gets ready for the faceoff between Goring and Bullard. Tonelli on the left wing, Nystrom on the right. McEwen and Langevin on defense for the Islanders. Bullard got the draw to McLeish. He was checked and went back to Price. Cleared to the Islander line and picked up by McEwen. Mike McEwen up left wing for Tonelli, who was knocked down by Baxter. Here's Ferguson moving in to McLeish. McLeish's shot spits the save. Pittsburgh came storming into the Islander zone. Nice passing play to put McLeish in on the left side, but Smith came up to the top of the goal crease.
There's the play, Ferguson to Rick McLeish. Is there anybody any more dangerous? He miscued on the shot, but Billy Smith had the angle. Smith, a big save as Pittsburgh comes right back. Islanders could get too anxious here, Jake. Now they want to go back and play. They want to just get back and play their game.
2 minutes and 7 seconds left. Mache on the draw. McEwen and McLeish went to the boards. McEwen came up with the puck. Back of the net and got it to Langevin. To Goring. Goring didn't see it. It hit the referee, I believe. Now Trache has got it to Langevin. Around to Mike McEwen. To Brian Trache. Trache up the middle. Three Penguins get back. The pass went to Nystrom. Can't slip around Price. Price and McLeish went off his stick. Back to Price in the corner. Clears it out to center ice. Off the skate of Denny Potvin. And Tonelli takes it. He and Potvin buck together. But Denny comes away with the puck. Hand over the line, right into the middle, it's shot,
Dion, the save, the rebound, and bang at it. It's on the doorstep, and Dion is stretched out diagonally. The puck is underneath him.
How can the man do it? But he did.
The Stormtroopers come right back again. Dennis Potvin leads the rush. Tonelli is moving down the left side quickly. On the other side, Butch Goring. There's the shot. Stopped by Dion. The rebound. You think it's going to go in. Goring misses it. A shot by Tonelli. And Dion has it underneath him. Tonelli falling backwards off balance. Couldn't get the puck up over the scroll. Dion.
Now Al Arbour sends out Brian Trotche. Mike Bossy and Clark Gillies. Here's another look at it.
Dennis Potvin. He's waiting, setting it up. There goes the shot. Stopped, couldn't hold on to it. Dion Goring, checked by Schutt. And John Tonelli falling. Had he been able to hold his balance, he may have been able to lift it over Dion.
Now here's a chance. Bossy with a shot. Dion got a piece of it. Bossy back to Potvin. Into Bossy, turns, put one out in front of the net, and it was cleared. Picked up by Schutt. A minute 20 left in regulation. Schutt to the Islander line. Slowed up by Trotche, who took him off the puck completely. Morrow back, out to Bossy. Bossy comes off the right wing side, giving to Denny Potvin. Potvin into center ice. He likes to dump it in, wide of Dion. Bossy went in after it, tied up by Schutt. And Price has dumped it down the ice, less than a minute to play. Bad play here for Pittsburgh because they get a faceoff from the Pittsburgh end of the ice.
Dion swings his stick at the goalpost. He knew there was no reason for his team to ice the puck. They have 54 seconds remaining. Obviously, there'll be a timeout called by somebody. I would think Eddie Johnson.
And we had a signal. Now Johnson is making player changes. Over the boards comes Boutette, Ferguson, and McLeish. Up comes Carlyle as well. The Islanders have sent Butch Goring into center ice. Wayne Center on the right, Bob Gordon on the left. McEwen and Longevin on the points. 54 seconds remaining in regulation time.
Last overtime game in this building, Jake, was made on 24th, 1980. You remember that? Bobby Nystrom missed the clutch at 7-11. The Stanley Cup.
Tonelli set him up with a pass from Lauren Henning at 7-11 to win the first Stanley Cup.
Butch Goring using a little sight on Boutette.
Now they line up, but not legally, so Goring and Boutette are waved out. Warren comes over to face off against Rick McLeish. Goring will go to the right. Wayne Center comes to the left side. McEwen comes in from the right point. Warren trying to pull the puck in. It went to the corner, cleared around the boards, and ahead to Pat Boutette to McLeish. McLeish hits center ice. They move it over the Islander line. McLeish to the left wing, but it is offside. Ahead of the play, George Ferguson. 44 seconds left.
Butch Goring coming back quickly to help his defense. Big factor. Offside as McLeish comes across the line. Boutette trying to get clear of Butch Goring. Went in offside. This is playoff hockey, Jigs, at its best.
And all these guys have been there before and they've done what they do so well. But it has been a nail-biter.
Couldn't be any more thrilling. 3-1. Pittsburgh led going into the third period. McEwen and Tonelli have both scored to tie it.
Brian Trotche takes the faceoff against Laurent. Trotche got it to Tonelli. Now to Brian Trotche. Cuts to the left side. Bumps it into the Pittsburgh zone. Carlyle around, intended for Schutt. Tonelli stepped in front of him. The puck went to Laurent. He couldn't clear it out. McEwen ties it up on the board. Laurent had fallen, and it's underneath him. 30 seconds left and a faceoff just inside the Pittsburgh zone.
Andy Saint-Laurent getting up slowly. He has to be a tired hockey player, but he doesn't feel it. He's too pumped. The game means too much. He's done so much to let it go. There's more to be done.
30 seconds, all that's remaining in regulation time. We're staring right down the gun barrel here in overtime. A dramatic way to end this series.
Almost unavoidable. 30 seconds, but again, you never know in hockey games such as this.
The puck went to the boards, cleared out by Schutt. Morrow chases it back into his own zone. Morrow and Potvin on defense. Trotche, Bossy, and Gillies up front with his backhanded through everybody into the Pittsburgh zone, and icing was waved off.
Well, Baxter from back of the net up the right side to McClelland. McClelland to Salouin. He was checked. Fossey played one off the boards. There is Salouin. Over to Price. Stolen by Fossey. 3 seconds left and he can't get it around Pat Price. And we'll go to overtime. There is the horn. Sudden death overtime will decide the victor and an opponent for the New York Rangers in the next round. They went to overtime Saturday in Pittsburgh, and the Penguins won. A year ago, the Penguins were eliminated in St. Louis in the fifth game of the series in the second overtime period. But we have got sudden death ahead. Sudden death for one, sudden life for the other.
Three in one of the most sensational hockey games in a long time. The Islanders rallying to tie the score. And my guest is Pete Wawerski of the Pittsburgh Press. And Pete, we have seen some superb goaltending over the last few seasons. I cannot remember a better performance than Michel Dion has given us tonight at Nassau Coliseum.
Well, the only thing that comes close was Greg Millen and Michael Ute last year in overtime of the Penguins' last game of the season, which was the fifth game of a preliminary round series against St. Louis. In St. Louis, both guys were phenomenal. Dion already tonight has surpassed it.
Now, Pete, you saw that game. How was it decided? At what point in the sudden death? And was it a fluke, a bad hop? Let's recount that one.
Well, it was in the second overtime. I believe it was something like 5 minutes and 32 seconds in. Pass in the left wing corner. There was a crowd. Puck got kicked out. I believe it was by Federko. Came out to Mike Crombie being alone in the slot and just banged it past Millen.
Pete Wawerski, the game has been a terrific drain on both teams, and you have to wonder a number of things. First of all, you've watched Michel Dion. Do you think he's fatigued, and do you think this fatigue will in any way affect him in the sudden death overtime, one way or another?
Well, he looked very weary there in the third period, especially after he got bounced off the post twice. Shortly thereafter, he was very slow getting up. I noticed after a shot that he went down a block, and it may have had something to do with the last two goals. But Michel has been kind of a guy who gets his strength from within. He gets himself fired up, and I'm sure he'll give as much as he can during the next how many minutes it takes.
Stan Fischler here with Pete Wawerski of the Pittsburgh Press. We have a 3-3 tie. Getting ready for sudden death overtime. Now, Pete, who of the Penguins have surprised you in this series?
Well, Andre St. Laurent, first of all. Knew he was a good defensive player. Didn't know he was that good because he never really had to stop a guy like Trottier five games in a row. Pat Price has come on strong the last three games, as have most of the Penguins. Dion, I don't know, there were a couple of minor surprises. In a negative way, Mike Bullard not getting his first goal until tonight. But I think another big boost for the Penguins so far has been Rick Kehoe. His two goals back in Pittsburgh were unexpected because in previous 34 games he had two for a career in the playoffs. And Paul Gardner playing pretty decent defense, took the puck from Morrow to set up Carlyle's goal. It was a good play, and he's not known for that.
Pete Wawerski, you saw the brilliant play of Randy Carlyle throughout this hockey game. One point he made a spectacular poke check to avert what looked like a point-blank Islander shot, and yet he was victimized. Did you see that as a bad bounce? How did you see that play?
Well, the way Lane's pass off the boards came out of Carlyle, he seemed to look at it, look away, look at it again. And he was in the process of moving his stick to get it down on the ice, and as he got it down on the ice, the puck skipped over it. That's, the way it looked to me.
Stan Fischler here with Pete Wawerski of the Pittsburgh Press. We are seeing one of the most excruciatingly exciting, that's a tough one, excruciatingly exciting aspects of professional hockey, the sudden death overtime. And Pete, over the years, sudden death games have frequently been decided by the lesser lights in hockey. It's absolutely impossible to predict. Do you have any idea about how you would see this overtime evolving?
Well, I'll tell you, I don't know whether Eddie Johnson's got three players on the ice who have not seen much ice time.
Who are they?
Peter Lee, Bobby Simpson, who's seen maybe one or two shifts, and Pat Graham. As was the case in St. Louis last year, Crombeam's line did not play. They had all been sick. They did not play, I think, the last period and a half, 40 minutes at least. And they had the fresh legs, came out, and produced the winning goal. Whether EJ opts for that or goes with the guys who've brung him, I don't know, and I wouldn't want to have to make his choice.
Very interesting point made by Pete Wawrzyski of the Pittsburgh Press. Whether or not the coach of the Penguins, Eddie Johnson, is going to go with his fresh players, and of course, equally fascinating to see what Al Arbour, the coach of the Islanders, does in this overtime. And Pete, Stefan Pearson, who started the game for the Islanders, apparently has been injured sufficiently to have been withdrawn from the lineup, and of course that does not help the Islanders.
Oh, not at all, because that leaves basically, I guess, Dennis Potvin as your really mobile defenseman, and Stefan has done a great job in the series, and that loss is going to be may prove telling.
Well, of course he has used Mike McEwen, and McEwen is quite good at lugging the puck. He's been the architect of several goals over the season with his very crisp passing play. So it's going to be very, very interesting to see what happens in this first sudden death overtime. We have a 3-3 tie, the Islanders and the Pittsburgh Penguins. We'll be back with more in just a moment.
In watching various sports shows around the country, let's just talk about this for a minute. So many commentators have picked on the National Hockey League's playoff format so many times, called it silly. If this is silly, I'm proud to be a part of it.
I love silly hockey, then. We'll be back for the start of the first overtime period in just a moment. You're watching New York Islanders hockey on SportsChannel.
Bourne and Gillies each with one, and in overtime, the Islanders, 15 wins, 5 losses. They lost in overtime in Pittsburgh on Saturday night. That extended the series to Sunday, and Pittsburgh won it 5-2.
Jiggs, this is the Islanders' 21st playoff series. They have won 15 and lost 5. The only series that the Islanders have lost after winning the opening game was to Toronto. You'll remember back to that fitful and fateful time in 1978.
We look down the New York Islander bench. Al Arbour has sent Butch Goring out to center. John Tonelli and Bob Nystrom on the wings. Danny Potvin and Ken Morrow on defense, and Bill Smith in goal. The Penguins, Sal Laurent will take the faceoff. Shut on the left side, McClelland on the right. Carlyle teamed up on defense with Greg Hoffman and Michel Dion in goal. Michel Dion psyching himself up back and forth in front of the Pittsburgh net. The puck dropped, it came back to Potvin. Danny Potvin into center. Across the Pittsburgh line, trying to feed it through to Tonelli. McClelland tying him up as they go to the corner. John Tonelli kicked it loose for Goring. Put it out in front. And it was picked off and brought out by Schutt. Schutt trying to play it to the right side to McClelland. It was too far ahead of him. There's Potvin rounding the gap. Danny Potvin into center ice. In the Pittsburgh line, Potvin trying to come in around the defense. The puck loose. Tonelli chased to the corner by McLeish. John Tonelli kicks it loose to Nystrom. Baxter, Tonelli still trying to jab it loose, and he knocked McCreesh down, and the puck is beneath the veteran Pittsburgh forward.
The Islanders want to keep the pressure on. They want to keep it down in Pittsburgh's end of the ice.
38 seconds gone in the overtime. General manager Bill Torrey did not go back to his seat in the rafters. He is in the doorway to the right of the Pittsburgh goal. Jay, Gillies, and Bossy now for the Islanders, and Sal Laurent is back to take the faceoff. Ferguson and McLeish with him. Jay won the draw, getting it back. Launching a shot off the stick of Ferguson, and it broke Ferguson's stick. George Ferguson kicked it around the board. Trache was grabbed by Price, got the puck to Bossy, back to Trache. Trache to Gillies, he shoots Dion on the save. Here's the place for Pittsburgh. It into center ice. Langevin is back. Langevin to Gillies, couldn't make contact with it. It's loose in the Pittsburgh zone, and the Islanders will be called for having iced the puck.
There's no doubt, Jiggs, that Michael Bossy is playing on a gimpy leg. He's having a little trouble operating.
as you see him try to push off and get his speed going. He does not have that little jump that Mike Fossey is famous for.
Well, Arbour makes a change on defense. Langevin and McEwen come to the players' bench. Morrow and Plotman are back. Eddie Johnson has Ferguson, McClelland, Bullard out on the ice. Bullard will take the faceoff here in the Islanders' zone. Price and Baxter on defense. And now Bob Bourne is sent over the boards, but Bruce Hood says no. Gillies will stay up there.
Strategy, a little floor, that gives Brian Truche just another breather.
On the draw, Bullard got it back. Baxter, a shot, glove saved by Bill Smith, who dropped it for Poppan. Poppan up the left side to Gillies, to Denny Poppan. Poppan starts out of his own zone with a pass to Morrow. Morrow into center ice, around McLeish, shot it around the boards in the Pittsburgh territory. Baxter is there. To Ferguson, to Bullard, they've got a two-on-one break. Bullard and McLeish, Bullard lines up, takes the shot, comes in, shoots, gets the save! Smith, a startling save off Bullard. What a break for the Penguins. Here comes Truche. Truche down the right side. Trying to come in around Price. Truche put on the brakes. Price hung with him and fed the puck off the boards and went to Bourne. Bourne to Truche back of the net. Ryan Truche put it out in front. Pick off by Bullard. Bullard to McLeish. Right side to Ferguson. Over the Islander line. Drop pass. Bullard with it. Bullard chased to the corner by McEwen. Bullard goes to the side of the net but couldn't center it. McLeish wraps one around behind the goal. Langevin now to Mike Fossey. To Truche. Three Penguins back. Truche shoots it in high off the stiff hand of Dion and into the crowd. 2 minutes and 11 seconds gone, and Montreal has been eliminated. Quebec Nordiques in overtime, and the Forum in Montreal have eliminated the Canadiens, and a goal by Hunter.
Dale Hunter, Mark Hunter.
Who are those Hunter kids anyway? There's one with Edmonton, one with Montreal, and one in Quebec. A Quebec Hunter.
Dale Hunter gets the goal for the Quebec Nordiques.
I'll be doggone.
This game almost came to an end. Bullard, what a move he makes on Ken Morrow. Takes the shot. What a save by Billy Smith. Rick McLeish going right across in front of him. And Mike Bullard, again, gives the New York Islanders fits.
Wayne Merrick shortening up on this faceoff. Knocked it away from Boutette. Carlyle in to pick it up for Pittsburgh. Randy Carlyle. It was Merrick, Taylor, and Bourne as Carlyle gave it to Gardner. Now to Boutette. That Boutette at the Islander line. Chased wide by Langevin. Boutette centers. Fits down to make the save. He doubled it. Then able to cover up.
Goaltenders getting a little jittery as Pittsburgh brings the puck under control into the Islanders, into the ice. Pat Boutette has had a fine series also as he gets partially around Langevin. In comes Merrick. There's the backhand. Smith had trouble getting the handle. Then he grabbed a hold.
Taylor skates out of the faceoff area. Comes over to talk to Merrick. Boutette on the draw for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Got the draw. Back it comes. And a long shot to a screen. Smith the save. Keogh and Merrick dumps it outside the blue line, but back with Pat Boutette. Over to Carlyle. Carlyle, a long slap shot wide of the Islander net. Bourne takes it off the boards and tipped it into center ice. That's Hoffman for Pittsburgh. For Gardner, backhands it into the Islander zone. Smith cuts it off. There's Mike McEwen in some traffic. Pass to Bourne. He's chased in deep by Keogh. Islanders having trouble getting out of their own end of the ice. Boutette stole the puck, gave it to Gardner, tipped it to the corner. Keogh check. Taylor sends Merrick out over the line. In the center ice. Merrick working on Baxter. Poked it around him, but couldn't catch up with it. Keogh got it to the blue line. Warren poked it in a little deeper. And there is Carlyle feeding it to center ice. Keogh drops it to Boutette. Boutette at the Islander line. Drop pass to Keogh. He was checked by John Tonelli. Keogh now to Gardner. And he missed the check from Nystrom and played it into the Islander zone. Langevin sends Nystrom up right wing. To Pat Price at the Pittsburgh zone. Baxter in the corner trying to tie it up. Nystrom got it loose for Tonelli. Comes up the left wing boards, and here comes Gardner. Knocked it into center ice. Poppan has it there. Poppan to Goring. Off his stick to Tonelli. Puts it in around Baxter. Tonelli out of the corner. The Goring, and it is broken up by Pat Price. Price off the boards. Cleared the puck ahead. Here's shot into the Islanders' zone. Tavares trailing. Shot fired to Twine. Comes up the right side. Krejci poked it out into center ice, but McClelland was back. It off the boards. Islanders chasing it. It's borrowed to the right side to Krejci. Ryan Krejci. Out of Clark Gillies. Gillies backhands it into the Pittsburgh zone, and Gillies collided with Hawkins. Carlyle around the board. Potvin came in off the point. And hit him. And it's cleared by Salarant. The Carlyle throw it from the corner shot. Oh, he won the save. Hawkins for the Penguins. Gillies slowed him up by a check. Now it's cleared ahead for Salarant. Salarant over the Islander line. Carlyle moves in with him. The pass deflected by Potvin. Ball has it back to the net. On the right side. Mike Fossey fires one in high and wide. It almost hit Krejci. Price with it. Islanders change on the fly. Price up the left side for Baxter. Baxter to the Islander blue line. Came over the line but was offside.
Both teams continue to skate well, Jakes. 5 minutes have now gone by in the overtime. The longest game the Islanders have ever played in overtime. 81 minutes and 20 seconds. Versus Buffalo back May 1st, 1980. Bobby Nystrom scored to make it 2-1. And at home, the longest game, 77 minutes, 13 seconds against the Bruins when Terry O'Reilly scored to win for the Bruins 4-3.
Now they watch Mike McEwen send Wayne Sutter in the right wing. Sutter in front to Brent, and he was bowled over by Baxter. Now comes McLeish, right side. Well, Bullard across the Islander line, back to McLeish. McLeish has shot, it hit Langevin, loose puck, McLeish ridden off the puck. Run in by Price. At Price, a drive! Wide of the net, and it comes to the blue line to Baxter. Baxter's shot, hit Born, Baxter with it again, a long shot went wide. Lodges in the mesh back of the Islander goal, and there's no further play. Faceoff to be outside the New York Islander blue line.
The longest the Penguins have gone in a hockey game, Jigs, 85 minutes, 16 seconds versus St. Louis last year, April 14th, when Mike Crombie scored to eliminate Pittsburgh 4-3. They lost.
Boy, that was a game that either team could have won in the first 4 or 5 minutes.
Right, you were at that game.
There were so many opportunities, breakaways even. Excellent saves and shots that went high over the crossbar and that type of thing. Now McEwen off the boards to Goring at center ice, into the middle for Tonelli. Tonelli across the Pittsburgh line, unable to get it to Nystrom, who headed for the net. Here's Tonelli, backing away from the check of Carlyle. Carlyle around the boards. Nystrom and Ferguson bumping into one another. And the puck comes loose. Bullard checked by Goring. Bullard picks it up now to the Islander line with McLeish and Ferguson. Bullard a slap shot and hit Langevin. Bullard picks it up, gives it to Carlyle. A shot blocked in front by Mike McEwen. McEwen sends Tonelli away on a breakaway. John Tonelli, Baxter catches up with him, hauls him down. No penalty, and out in front by Kinnisera. Back here, he scores! Out of his own! They're going to the next round against the New York Rangers. Pittsburgh is eliminated at 6:19. Shake hands with Eddie Johnson. They'll line up at center ice here in a moment for the traditional handshake.
The Northern Islander, Jakes, has missed going over to shake the coach of the Pittsburgh Penguins' hand, Eddie Johnson.
The goal is going to John Tonelli. Is the time as you see Pat Price, Butch Goring, McClelland, there's Dion with Wainwright without his helmet. Salomon had himself one sensational series.
As how about Mike Buller takes number 22? Baxter has played an outstanding series. No matter what he was coming in, he was outstanding also. The fans are giving the Pittsburgh Penguins what they deserve, a standing ovation as they leave the ice.
You see the remains of a traditional handshake. John Tonelli put his arm around Baxter and now skates toward the dressing room. It was Tonelli's goal at 6:19 that sends the New York Islanders into the next round against the New York Rangers here at the Nassau Coliseum on Thursday night. Michel Dion still shaking his head as he leaves the ice. Here is Tonelli's goal.
He scored the goal, Jiggs, at 6:19, but he scored the biggest one last period. Look at Tonelli as he goes in against Baxter. Down, he's up, he's gotten the puck out in front. Bobby Nystrom, checked by Carlyle, and there's the shot by John Tonelli. He's done it again in one hockey game. He has scored two goals that he'll remember for the rest of his life. The tying goal and the winning goal. Look at the play there by McEwen as he breaks up Randy Carlyle's play. And out come the Islanders. This is going to be the goal. Tonelli is so tired, he can't get away from Baxter. He tries the shot anyway. Dion steers it aside. But he gets up again. What a heart. John Tonelli to Nystrom. He's checked by Carlyle. And Tonelli takes the rebound. And he puts it in the top of the open net. Dion. Incredible what Dion has done in the nets for the Pittsburgh Penguins. There they are. They are a happy group, and they would have to say somewhat lucky. They didn't get a break until the third period.
Oh, my. You can say that again over and over. The Islanders appeared to be in trouble. It was scoreless at the end of the first period. They were down 3-1 at the end of the second period. They were still down 3-1. With 5:27 to play in the game in regulation time. That's when McEwen scored the power.
This was high drama from beginning to end. The Penguins, underdogs, came from behind in this game. They went ahead 3-1. The Islanders looked like they were out of it. The Islanders rallied late in the third period, tied the game. Michel Dion, brilliant in goal for the Penguins, and the Islanders, after having a couple of scares in that overtime, Tonelli got the goal, but the man on my right, Bob Nystrom, making a dramatic comeback for the Islanders, instrumental in this victory. And Bob, you were on the ice for the winning goal. I'd like you to recapitulate the play from the very beginning in the Islander zone to the denouement when the puck went into the net.
Well, first of all, Mike Bullard came in and he made a heck of a move, and he dropped the puck back to one of their defensemen, and he went in to take a shot, and Mike McEwen came out and made a super play. He blocked the shot, and he saw John Tonelli breaking in on a breakaway, and he threw it up to him, and Johnny got pulled down, and he still got up. I mean, he was up before even Baxter, and he threw it out to me in front of the net, and I tried to make a move, and Pat Buttet came back and hooked me, and the puck was just laying there, and Johnny just threw it over top of my head into the net. It was unbelievable. I couldn't believe it.
Bob Nystrom, the Islanders looked like they were in big trouble in this hockey game. Not only were they trailing, you were trailing 3-1, but you were facing an indomitable goaltender in Michel Dion. Now, what was the feeling in the Islander dressing room between the second and third periods?
Well, I felt the attitude was pretty good, you know, considering the predicament we were in, down 3-1. I still felt the guys had that feeling that we could come back and win the game. I felt one goal and then start to panic, and then we could start pressure on, and that's exactly what happened. You know, Mike came up with a real and sticking in the tying goal, and from that point on I didn't have any win.
Fans of the Islanders were in by the, excuse the expression of the Islanders,